brother.
An exciting adventure!
Oh, boy, let's go!
Pirates!
The Adventures of Raggedy Ann and Andy, Saturday!
Love the feeling
when Saturday rocks on CBS!
With the McDonald's Happy Meal, I always have a whale of a time!
On-the-go Happy Meal comes in a bag or a box. There's a picture on the bag, stickers for the box. You can take them anywhere, all around the clock. Carry things, too. Carry things, fro. That's why we call them on-the-go. On-the-go Happy Meal, only at McDonald's.
Superman!
He's tough stuff!
Super action starting September 17th!
When Saturday rocks on CBS!
And now, this message.
Superman, listen to these.
Details on specially marked M&M's packages for the 60 Years with Mickey game.
And now back to Raggedy Ann and Andy.
Yeah! Jonathan ran for his life through the dark, twisting castle turret away from the most frightening and hideous creature, the beastly ghost. Jonathan had to find somewhere, anywhere to hide before the beastly ghost got him. Meanwhile, Jonathan's sister, Rebecca, was frantically searching for her brother. And when she heard the ghostly screech, it sent icy fingers down her back. Rebecca only hoped she wasn't too late. She raced up the stairs to the corridor.
Jonathan!
Rebecca was frantic. Jonathan, she called, but the only answer was...
Marcella, time for dinner.
Huh? Okay, Mom, I'm coming. Isn't this the best story? I think this is my favorite book, Ghosts and Other Scary Stuff.
Marcella!
I'm coming, Mom! Okay, so I'll see you first thing in the morning. We can finish reading the story then.
Wow, I love that scary story. Oh, especially the part where that ugly, disgusting, repulsive, creepy...
Oh, get on with it, Andy.
Oh, yeah, Ghost was chasing Jonathan.
And the howling part. Ow!
Well, I can't wait to find out how the story ends.
I hope it's happy.
Oh, naturally.
Who cares? In my opinion, the entire story is just plain ridiculous.
Good thing we don't want your opinion.
No! The point is that there is no such thing as ghosts. It's common knowledge, you know. Therefore, anyone who believes in such a thing is a big baby.
Oh, no! A ghost!
Okay, you two, what's the big idea?
Very funny. It's just a storm. What a bunch of chickens.
I think we're all just a little jumpy from the spooky story, Grouchy Bear.
I keep telling you, there are no such things as ghosts.
So what's that noise?
Andy, Raggedy Dog, we've had just about enough of your silly stunts.
It wasn't us.
There it is again.
Well, if it isn't you, Andy, and it isn't Raggedy Dog. How strange.
I don't think strange covers it. We're talking totally weird. Somebody or thing is out there in the playhouse.
Well, we know it is definitely not a ghost because there are no such things.
Then you'll go out there to check it out, right?
Me? Oh, no, Okay, I am delighted to go. Outside in the driving wind and rain, just to prove you're all a bunch of scaredy cats. After all, I know that ghosts do not exist. Ghost! There's a ghost in the playhouse!
Quit fooling around, Grouchy Bear.
Yeah, what did you really see?
I'm telling you, I saw a ghost in the playhouse. Come out and see for yourself.
I suppose that's what we should do. Come on. Well, you guys can go without me.
Oh, my. Oh, the place has calmed down since I saw it.
Whistle, whistle, where are you? I'll find that whistle. And then I'll be able to stop those kids.
I'm warning you, there is a ghost in there.
Humans, at this hour, I'd better hide.
I tell you, I saw it.
Well, I'm not afraid of any dumb old ghost. Come on.
This isn't right.
It all looks right to me.
Look, we did our joke with the sheet, and now this is your joke, right, Grouchy Bear?
Joke? He was sitting in this chair, only it was hanging in midair. No!
You're not kidding. You really do think you saw a ghost, don't you? We did think we saw something before. Maybe we should check it out a little more.
One ghost coming up.
You got it.
Okay, ghost. If you're really ghost material, materialize!
Amateurs.
Huh? What have you got? Whatever it is, it's not a ghost.
It looks like a bird.
Oh, let me see.
So that's where my whistle is.
Hey, guys, over here!
What are you on to, Raggedy Dog?
The teapot!
Oh, no. The gentleman I saw was too big to get into a teapot.
Oh, my gosh. It's on automatic pilot.
Give it to me. I want it now!
No!
It's the ghost!
Indeed. And now that we've proven that, let's get out of here!
I'd like to leave now. Police!
You're going nowhere until I get it. Now, which one of you has it?
Both. If you mean fear, leave.
Whistle?
Let's just give him what he wants. Whistle!
Not your whistle! The whistle!
Great. I'm not only seeing ghosts, I don't understand them.
Oh, what whistle?
You know what whistle? And if you won't hand it over, I'm going to terrify it out of you, one by one, when you least expect it.
You know, there's something familiar about that ghost.
That's great, Anne, but what are we gonna do?
We stay together. Look, everyone hold hands.
I am not a hand holder.
Come on, Grouchy Bear, just this once. It's for our protection. Hold on to Camel.
Well, okay, just this once. You're not Camel!
Where did Camel go?
He's gone.
Great, just bait. First a ghost, now a lost Camel.
Look! Footprints in the wet paint.
Yeah, Camels. You know, the prints lead to the closet. Camel, are you here?
The ghost must have gotten him. What's that slime-sneezing creep want with Camel?
I don't know, but it looks like they went through this wall.
Where are we going?
Where are we going?
Everyone okay?
Well, the ghost said it was gonna try to scare us. He's doing a great job.
Worse than that, we're lost.
And even worse than that, there's no sign of Camel.
Yeah, Camel's footprints are gone.
What else can go wrong?
Please, don't ask.
Anne? Shh, I'm thinking. We've got to figure out some answers. And they're probably as plain as the nose on my face.
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Huh? Wet purple paint. That means Camel must have been here.
So if we feel around for wet paint, we can follow his trail.
Okay, let's go. But carefully. Who knows what we're going to find?
Certainly was.
Look! It's Camel! Come on, let's get him and get out of here!
Ah, perfect they're here. I'm so good at what I do.
I've got this funny feeling like something is following us. Oh, no, I'm just too spooked. No.
Oh, boy, am I glad to see you guys.
We're glad to see you too, Camel. Hold on. I'll get you down.
Yeah, just as fast as we can. Boy, this place is
beastly.
You called my name?
Oh, no!
I knew it.
Oh, the ghost!
Yeah, beastly the ghost. Hey, wait a sec. That's not just any ghost. It's the ghost from Marcella's book.
That's right. I came out of that book so I could change the ending of the story. And I can get what I want. Book it over!
Listen, you beastly. What are you talking about?
Well, Raggedy, how do you like your ghost story now?
And now, this message.
Popping in my head like popcorn, popping and popping in my head. Corn pops popping, it's all I think about. Pop, pop, popping, they keep popping in my head. Corn pops popping, gotta get a taste. I can't stop popping. Corn pops popping, popping in my head.
Kellogg's Corn Pops. You can't stop thinking about that sweet popcorn taste. Part of this complete breakfast.
Corn pops popping, popping in my head.
Pop!
Introducing pocket rockers. Tiny tapes, tiny players.
Down on the corner, out in the street, pocket rockers are playing where the music feels the beat.
Pocket rockers, play them here, wear them anywhere.
Down on the corner, out in the street, pocket rockers are playing where the music feels the beat.
Tiny players, tiny tapes, pocket rockers, tapes and accessories sold separately, batteries not included, from Fisher Price.
Here's something new and juicy. Here's something a whole lot of fun. New lifesavers, fruit juice or candy. Real juice in everyone.
That's true.
Winter juice in fruit juice or candy.
Strawberry.
You think they grow on a tree?
Citrus.
Here's something new and juicy.
Punch it.
Here's something a whole lot of fun. New lifesavers, fruit juice or candy.
Berries.
Real juice means a whole lot.
You can mush them, you can push them, you can squish them, you can't stop. Pop, pop,
smush.
Hide the smushies in your pocket, stuff another in a locket, you can't stop.
Pop, pop, smush.
Unswish them right before their eyes, when you hide them, they'll surprise. You can't stop.
Pop, pop, smush.
Everybody smush
your smushies.
Everybody
smush your smushies.
Everybody
smush your smushies.
And now back to Raggedy Ann and Andy.
Yeah! When you've had enough, call me. We can talk about the whistle!
They're getting tighter!
Hey, let me go! Hey! Get your mitts off, you pickpockets! Give me those!
What? Gosh! I forgot I had that bird thing! I bet that's the whistle! I've got to get it! Got it!
Everyone, wiggle your fingers!
Oh, and to think we had the darn thing all along!
Yeah, but we still have to figure out what to do with it!
Well, I know one thing. We're not giving it to...
Don't say that word, Camel.
Don't say beastly.
You called?
Oh, no.
Worse than a ghost who flaunts his haunting.
Do something, someone.
You already have, Camel.
Huh?
We'll have a nice game of hide and seek.
You got it.
Where did they go?
Not yet. He's not going to let up until he changes that story ending.
Well, we don't have the book, so let's get out of here. Ooh. Ghosts and other scary stuff. No.
That's the book! That's it!
Yeah, the book he came out of.
With the whistle! Then he somehow lost the whistle, and we found it. That whistle's the key to getting rid of him.
I know. We've got to get the whistle and Beastly back into the book. Chapter 2. Through the Dark Twisting Castle Turret. Too early. We've got to get him back into the story at just the right place.
You mean we're actually going to get into the book? Sure. If Beastly came out of it, he can take us back inside. Right in. I can't believe I said it!
Believe it!
I want it now!
Oh, no!
We'll use it to get in and out of the book.
I'll get it!
Grouchy Bear, you can pull us back.
Fine with me. I didn't like the story anyway.
I'll get you, Raggedies!
Oh, it's pretty dangerous going into a story like this.
Uh-huh. If we don't do this right, we could be stuck in the book forever.
Oh, I thought so.
Hurry, Andy. Hurry!
Look, we're here to help. Your brother's in big trouble, and you probably are too.
I know. In fact, excuse me, I gotta go find him. Sorry.
No, come back. We'd better follow her.
Wait, Andy. I think if we figure out what to do with the whistle, the story will be back on track.
And then we can go home.
So let's blow it. Hey!
Wow, it's some kind of laboratory.
This guy must be a relative of Rebecca and Jonathan's.
Yeah, like their great-great-grandfather.
Look, over here, a diary. December 14th, 1888. Today I finally rid the castle of the beastly ghost.
I'm coming!
He's back here in the story, all right.
Hurry! Finish reading it, Anne. We don't have much time.
Read the ghost with my latest invention, a whistle, which you blow three times and the ghost will disappear. That's it.
Wow, he was the first original Ghostbuster.
We have to leave the whistle right here for Rebecca to find.
Too late! We're gonna be stuck here forever!
Grouchy Bear! Grouchy Bear!
Wake up!
Grouchy Bear!
Wake up!
Grouchy Bear!
Wake up!
What?
Grouchy Bear!
Wake up!
Kids don't find the whistle.
Die! Leave me alone!
you fall asleep like that? We could have been stuck in there.
Well, it took you long enough.
It was just a few chapters, Grouchy Bear.
Oh, and everybody, I had the strangest, no, the weirdest dream last night that the beastly ghost was here. I guess I just couldn't wait to finish reading the story. Oh, there's my book. I've been looking all over for it. We can read the story right now. Jonathan could hear the beastly ghost coming closer and closer.
Ah! Leave me alone! No, help!
Meanwhile, Jonathan's sister, Rebecca, continued her search. She called out, Jonathan! But there was no answer. Rebecca had never felt so alone and so afraid. By happenstance, she leaned against a hidden panel in the wall and fell backwards. Into a secret room. It was really Rebecca and Jonathan's great-great-grandfather's laboratory, where Rebecca found a diary. On top of the diary was a very special-looking whistle, which the diary said if Rebecca blew, would get rid of the beastly ghost. And so, at that very moment, just as the beastly ghost was about to get Jonathan, the cat was struck with the strangest whistle sound imaginable. Whistle sound made the awful beastly ghost disappear. Jonathan raced off to find Rebecca, who was looking for him. Oh, she was relieved to find her brother all right. And they lived happily ever after. Gosh, what a great story. But I'm sure glad there's no such thing as real ghosts, except in books.
And now, this message.
Superman, listen, please.
We're in some wild shape!
With the stars and going to the beach!
And we're big time into California Dream Barbie.
California Dream Barbie's into fashion fun. She's into changing to bikinis in the California sun. She's into taking shots.
Palm tree earrings.
She's into laughing a lot. You know we're into it too. We just can't stop.
We're into Barbie!
California Dream Barbie doll comes with a Beach Boys record for you. Surf and shop and dolls all sold separately. From Mattel.
Wake up to the hot taste of Kellogg's Pop Tarts.
So hot.
Real fruit fillings give Pop-Tarts an incredible taste. So hot, they're cool. Now with Pop-Tarts' new family pack, free binoculars.
Cool!
I want to see!
Wow!
I want to see!
Sure. See?
Free in Pop-Tarts.
Thanks for helping put away our dinosaur collection, Ronald.
You're welcome. There, the box is full.
Got room in there for one more?
Well, I guess so.
Okay, Spock, jump in.
When you get an on-the-go Happy Meal box, you could carry your ape, 12 tapes, or a man made of blocks. When you get an on-the-go Happy Meal bag, you could carry your puppet, a trumpet, or a silly gag. One on-the-go box or bag with every Happy Meal you buy at McDonald's. You can collect all four.
Hey, Vern, it's Ernest.
He's so crazy.
Know what I mean?
Starting September 17th, it's gonna be wild.
When Saturday rocks on CBS.
And now back to Raggedy Ann and Andy.
A locomotive, able to leap tall buildings in a single bound. Superman! Yes, Superman! strange visitor from another planet who came to Earth with powers and abilities far beyond those of mortal men. Superman! Who, disguised as Clark Kent, mild-mannered reporter for a great metropolitan newspaper, fights the never-ending battle for truth, justice, and the American way.
Superman will return after these messages.
Surprise touches her butterfly, it starts growing again.
Oh, Dolly, Dolly, my Dolly Surprise.
You'll love the way her hair grows before your eyes. Dolly Surprise, each sold separately from Play School.
Matt Collins has been spectacular on the mound. Now he's looking hot and thirsty. He checks first. Goes to his rosin bag. Goes to his Kool-Aid sports coolers. And he takes a long, cool gulp. Matt pitches. It's hit deep. Matt goes back. And he's got it.
It's new Kool-Aid Sports Coolers juice drink. Big time taste for big time thirst.
And the fans are going wild.
Saturday Rocks.
Oh, yeah.
On CBS.
Stay tuned for Muppet Babies, followed by
Huey's Playhouse.
And now back to Superman.
Sure, after this complete breakfast, including my Frosted Flakes, they bring out the tiger in you.
Good, you'll need it.
Good, they're great.
You'll show them you're a tiger. Show them what you can do. The taste of Tony's Frosted Flakes.
Wow.
Bring out the tiger in you.
You can get a frisbee fly and amaze your friends with your virtuosity.
Virtue what?
Even with friends as dumb as mine. One free Frosted Flakes.
Baskin-Robbins gives you a lot to cheer about with an NFL football helmet sundae. Two scoops of your favorite ice cream. Your choice of our cheeriest toppings. All served in a mini football helmet. You can pick your favorite NFL team or collect all 28.
All the Baskin-Robbins stand up and shout!
A Baskin-Robbins two-scoop sundae served in a mini helmet. And the helmet is free.
The pond is under attack. Get in. Just as I suspected, the enemy is approaching. Kermit, this is is your big chance to do your duty for pond and country.
Don't worry, Captain. I'm a great shot with torpedoes. I'll be the sailor for the job.
No, no. We don't need any more sailors. What we need is a torpedo.
Torpedo? Hey, where are you taking me?
Load the torpedo!
I had to ask.
Fire! Torpedo!
No one.
What's the matter? Never seen a humming weirdo before? Wow! You're the cutest humming pig I've ever seen! Hey, how'd you like to hum with me? Hey! You think maybe I could give you a kiss? Oh, boy!
Hanzo, shut off the alarm, will ya?
Get out of my pajamas!
Why are we on the floor?
Hey, that's my foot!
I'm hungry.
What time is it anyway?
Breakfast time!
Ooh, my tummy! It is breakfast time.
Piggy's right. Let's go see if breakfast is ready.
Yeah! Let's go!
I'm starving.
Hurry up! Not again.
I didn't do it. Honest, guys.
The rain soaked in newspaper and now it's ruined.
Gosh, that's too bad, Nanny.
Sorry, Nanny.
What a bummer.
Gosh, Nanny sure wasn't her regular happy self this morning.
Maybe she had a bad dream about her bedroom being invaded by a squadron of unidentified flying grapefruits.
Fuzzy?
Unidentified flying yams?
Excuse me, Fuzzy, but I think your brain needs rewinding.
Whoa! Gee, thanks, Gonzo. I feel better already.
Hey, you guys, you know why Nanny's so upset?
Why?
Because she loves to read the newspaper in the morning, and her paper is wrecked.
Kermit's right. She threw away her paper because it got all wet.
Maybe we could get her another paper.
How are we going to do that?
We could go back in a time machine and hold an umbrella over the newspaper so it doesn't... get wet.
I know. We can make her another newspaper.
But we don't know anything about making newspapers.
Yeah, the only training I've had in the newspaper business is when I was housebroken.
It can't be that hard. I'll be the editor.
I could be the music reporter.
That's great, Ralph. And Skeeter, you could be the sports reporter.
Right, Chief.
And Piggy, you can be the movie reviewer.
Oh, goody! I love movies, Kermit.
Gonzo?
Yeah?
You be the photographer.
Great! I'll get undercover pictures of life on Mars. This Martian disguise fools them every time. Whoa!
What are you going to do, Animal?
Me not know.
I know. Animal can help me. I'm going to do the comic page.
Oh, good idea, Fuzzy.
Come on, Animal.
Okay.
Let me see. What kind of comic strip would Nanny like?
Funny. Blah, 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 blah.
Good idea. I'll do one about a funny bear. I'll call it Fozzie's Funnies. Hey, this is great. I think I'll tell a joke. What do you call it when an elephant dances in a china shop?
Huh? Me not know.
You call it break dancing. Get it? Break dancing? Waka waka waka.
Boo!
Wow, a balloon! That's the way people talk in comic strips.
Balloons, fun!
Hey, it's not that kind of balloon animal.
Fun!
Wow! Those balloons are dangerous. Maybe if I just think instead of talk, I won't make any more balloons.
Good thinking.
Oh no! Fox balloons! I'm getting out of here before I get squished! Yo! Whoa! Go away, you stupid balloons! Shh! Don't say anything, animal!
Okay!
No!
Blammo!
What's going on, Fozzie?
I got the comic pages ready for printing.
Hey, that's great!
Oh, no! Yay!
What did I say?
Balloon!
Here's the comic section, Scooter. Get it ready for paste up, will you?
Sure thing, Kermit.
Stop the presses! Stop the presses!
Gonzo, we haven't even started them yet.
Really?
Nope. Why did you want me to stop them anyway?
I don't know. That's what they always say in newsrooms.
Oh, boy.
It's time for Rona Piggy's movie review! This movie is called Phantom of the Opera. It's about a lousy rock musician who wishes he played piano like Lionel Richie. But when his records don't sell, he decides to be an actor and tries out for the part of Tarzan. But he's too ugly to be Tarzan, so he decides to play Dracula instead. The end. Yakapatiri, what a lousy movie. On Rona Piggy's scale of 1 to 10, I give it a -3. Here, Scooter, paste up this review in the movie section.
Sure thing, Piggy.
Hey, Skeeter, how are you coming with the sports section?
Be ready in a minute, Kermit.
Good afternoon, sports fans. This is Skeeter coming to you from Muppet Stadium with World Series highlights. It was a great game today. In the first inning, some players watched a UFO fly over the stadium. Fortunately, it turned out to be just a baseball. When the team's coach found out it was the umpire's birthday, he sang happy birthday to him and did a little dance. Later, the hometown manager and the umpire discussed the recipe for hometown hot dogs. Here's my sports report, Chief.
Hearing. Looks good, Skeeter.
Hey, Kermit, how about printing a newspaper joke on the front page?
Huh?
Like this one. What's black and white and red all over?
Aw, gee, Fozzie, everybody knows that joke.
They do?
Mm-hmm. Newspapers are black and white and red all over.
gosh, that's not the joke I was thinking of. I thought what was black and white and red all over was a skunk covered with strawberry jam. Phew, I'd rather be hit by a tomato any day. Thanks.
Muppet Babies will return after these messages.
This is our bus. This is our bus driver.
This is fun.
Fruit corners for roll-ups.
We love our fruit roll-ups. They make a big ass slip.
Fruit
corners, fruit roll-ups.
Ta-ta-ta.
We love to let them rip.
Let's have more.
Feel fruit fun.
Roll the fruit
one. We love the roll-ups.
Introducing the great big taste of new watermelon fruit roll-ups.
The cookie crust.
Just checking the traffic.
Cookie crust. This scheme to get cookie crisp isn't taking off.
Who can blame me? It looks like little chocolate chip cookies.
And it's part of this complete breakfast.
If you like cookies, you'll love Cookie Crisp.
Call me Lucky. I got two decoder pins free inside Cookie Crisp. I wrote the message in invisible ink so no enemy could see it. Then the chief decoded it with the other pin, and I saved the world again. You can get both pins free in Cookie Crisp cereal.
Centurion! Power Extreme!
Jake Rockwell, Detonator, and Hacker each sold separately.
Evil Hacker attacks Jake Rockwell.
Eat this, Centurion.
I need a more powerful weapon. Energize Detonator. Now try my diet.
This will stop you.
Piece of cake. And now for you. I'm out of here. You're history.
New Centurions. Detonator, Jake Rockwell, and Hacker come as shown. Each sold separately.
And now back to Muppet Baby.
Here's the latest scores, Kermit. 3-1, 7-4, 10-0. And here's a partial score that just came in. 2.
Huh? Gee, thanks, Skeeter.
Kermit, I need a photo for the front page.
Well, that's Gonzo's department. Gee, I wonder where he is. Ralph, what's Gonzo doing?
I think he's under the couch talking to the dust balls.
There must be some Martians around here somewhere. I knew you were hiding under here. I'm Ace Photographer Gonzo of the Daily Muppet. Take me to your leader. Hey, where'd you go? I just know there's life here on Mars. And when I snap a picture of a real live Martian, it'll be the story of the century. Maybe the rocks on Mars are actually super intelligent beings. Take me to your leader. Oh, I get it. You are the leader. So, tell me, what's the haps on Mars, Rocky old buddy? The silent type, huh? Oh, well, at least I can get a picture. Smile. Boy, there's gotta be something more lively around here than this. Maybe there's a whole civilization of Martians living underwater. Huh, I was right. That's the weirdest looking Martian I ever saw. Take me to your leader. I don't have a leader. I'm your reflection, Torpedo Nose. Sometimes I think my imagination has an imagination of its own. I'll find life on this planet if it's the last thing I do.
This is Chief Editor Kermit. Send up our music reporter. Ralph!
You called, Chief?
Yeah. I want you to go out and get an interview with Nanny's favorite rock group.
Gee, I didn't know Nanny dug rock music.
Sure. Nanny told us that she used to like the music of something called, the Big Bands. Remember?
Big Bands. This must be the right place, eh, animal?
Big band!
Boy, the dudes who play these instruments have got to be huge!
Whoa! Big drums!
Wow, Nanny was right! These big bands are great!
How are you coming with that music review, Ralph?
It's all ready, Chief.
Huh? What kind of review is this?
Well, I don't know how to write words, so I wrote it in music.
Sheesh.
Boy, I'm bushed. I've looked everywhere, and there isn't a sign of life on this planet. I guess I'll have to rocket back to the nursery and give Kermit the bad news.
Bad news?
Oh, hiya, fellas.
Bleep, say green cheese.
Green cheese! Yum! Blue cheese!
Run for your life! The Martians are coming!
Oh, don't be ridiculous, Gonzo!
There's no such thing as Martians.
Quick, Skeeter! Call out the Marines! The Martians have landed!
Gonzo, can't you see I'm busy? I don't have time for games!
Scooter, stop the presses! Make a new headline! Martians invade Earth!
Quit goofing off, Gonzo! The news is serious business!
You're telling me? Boy! Stand back, you bug-eyed freaks! One more step, I open this closet! All right, you asked for it!
Gonzo, will you stop shaking the couch and come out of there?
Looking for me?
Don't do that, Gonzo!
Bad vibes!
Hurry up, guys! It's almost time to go to press!
Wait a minute! What if Nanny wants to find a job or needs to buy a used car? Fuzzy's right! We need some classified ads!
Me do! Help wanted! Gardener! Used cars! New tires! Good paint! Convertible! For sale! 5 cents!
Animal, watch it!
Thanks, Animal.
Welcome.
Okay, guys, it's time to go to press.
Let's do it.
Skippy.
Oh, boy.
All right.
News, we give you the news.
The hottest, the greatest,
and certainly the latest.
A story breaks somewhere in the city. That's where we gotta go.
The city in a great big hurry.
Learning everything that you wanna know.
We get the facts. We run right back to the office in the nick of time.
To make the deadline with our headline at the Daily Muppet. At the Daily Muppet.
Who? What? When?
reports.
I can do celebrity interviews.
We cover it all. We're big and small. We're busy every day of the week.
From Monday to Sunday, at the Daily Muppet. At the Daily Muppet.
Hey, everybody! Stop the press!
Why, Hot Story?
You ate my dress!
The cake is set. We're ready to roll, to bring the morning paper to you.
So we can shout it, read all about it, in the Daily Muppet.
Extra, extra!
In the Daily Muppet.
Get your paper!
Daily Muppet.
So in you go,
the Daily Muppet!
Yeah!
Here you go, Scooter. Let's get this stuff on the presses and get this paper printed up.
Right, Chief.
But there's only one page.
Aw, no problem. This should do it.
Gonzo, that's blank paper.
So what? Nobody ever reads any of that inside stuff anyway.
Okay, let's deliver Nanny's paper.
My goodness! What's this?
It's your newspaper, Nanny.
Yeah, we made it ourselves.
Because we know how much you like to read the newspaper every day.
Why, that's sweet of you kids.
I did the sports section, Nanny.
That's very nice, Skeeter.
And I wrote the music review.
Uh-huh.
And I drew the funnies, Nanny.
Oh, well, they're very cute, Fozzie.
Want ads.
That's right. Animal did the want ads.
No, me want ads. Good news.
Thanks a lot, kids. This is going to be the best paper I've ever read.
She likes it.
Yippee!
We did it.
We're real newspaper makers.
Yay!
Oh, what's the matter, Gonzo?
Ah, gee, Kermit, I never got my photo of the Martian invasion of Earth.
Well, that's because there aren't any little green men, Gonzo. Just little green frogs.
I'll be in your band, Gonzo.
Don't be silly. You can't be in my rock band, Kermit.
Why not?
Because you're not a rock. Why aren't you guys playing? Is it something I said? Don't I pay you enough? What was that? Of course. How could I have been so stupid? I remembered the rocks, but I forgot the rules. One, two, three, four.
Hey, find a good seat and tune up your ears. Muppet Babies are going to enter a songwriting contest.
And I can sing it like Pity Parton, a marching song.
This song is called, Computer Scooter.
Yay! Yeah, like what's going on, man?
I'm
going
to do a funny song. This is Fuzzy Bear, and my song is called How to Tell Chicken Jokes Without Laying an Egg. Hey, don't you guys throw anything besides tomatoes? Oh, sorry I asked.
So, hold your horses and get comfortable. You won't want to miss a beat.
Gee.
Muppet Babies will return after these messages.
Once a person discovers new strawberry Newtons, he doesn't want to share them with anyone.
No!
Silly! New strawberry Newtons.
We got a game going!
Full of real chewy fruit.
Wanna play?
Tucked inside a very quiet cookie.
Wanna pitch?
Mmm.
The
and bring out the Newtons.
Delicious Newtons cookies. So fruit chewy, you'll want them for yourself.
We'll let you win.
I never go anywhere without my newborn puppy pack.
How puppies like to see new places sure does brighten up their lonely faces.
The Pound Puppies Newborns Puppy Pack comes with two lovable, huggable newborns.
Pack up, it's bedtime.
The Newborns Puppy Pack, it packs a pack of love.
Pound Puppy, you're my tiny traveling puppy love.
The Pound Puppies Newborns Puppy Pack, it comes with two Pound Puppies Newborns, new from Tonka.
Piggy's post office is now open for business. Can I help you?
Yeah. How do you send smog to a friend?
What?
You put it in a box and send it dirty airmail. That's a post office joke. Waka waka waka.
Well, I've got a better joke, Fozzie. How do you send lousy comedians to a friend?
I give up. How?
Airhead Express mail.
Oh.
Next!
One sheet of stamps, please.
Just a moment. Hey, where are those stamps, Rolf?
Coming right up. There. That's everything. Here you are, Piggy.
One sheet of stamps. Aren't they pretty?
But they all have pictures of you on them.
Naturally. It's my post office.
Huh? What's that?
It's the Pony Express.
Oh, I see. No, it's the Weirdo Express.
So, Weirdo, where's the mail?
Mail? I know I forgot something.
I sure hope weirdness isn't contagious.
It's my latest invention, Beaker. I call it air mail.
Oh, business was good today. Nobody breathed. What do you think you're doing?
Special delivery!
Hi, kids.
Hi, Nanny.
Hi, Nanny.
This letter just came for Rolf.
Huh? A real letter? For me?
I wonder who it's from.
Go ahead, open it.
Wow, this is incredible.
What's it say?
How should I know? I can't read. Would you read it for me, Nanny?
Why, certainly, Rolf. Dear toy piano owner, that's you, Rolf. The Tiny Way Piano Company is having its annual Young Person Songwriting Contest and would like to invite you to enter. The winning song will be played on the radio.
Gee, you're a great songwriter, Rolf. You win for sure.
I guess I could give it a try.
You let me know when you're done, Rolf, and I'll mail in your entry.
Let's get our instruments so we can help Rolf.
Yippee!
Let's go! Hey.
I wonder what kind of song I should write.
I know. Make it a funny song about a hot dog gargling root beer who gets mustard on his guitar and...
Fuzzy!
You're right. It would be better if he gargled the mustard and spilled the root beer on his guitar and...
Hold your hand right there, Fuzzy, and whatever you do, don't let go.
Hey, I know. I'll write a classical song.
Classical?
Well, I...
Go ahead, Rolf. We're ready to record.
Okay. I'm Rolf the dog, and this is my song.
Oh.
I can't write a song with my piano out of tune.
I know. Take your piano to an auto mechanic. They do great tune-ups.
You really think they can tune my piano, Fozzie?
Sure.
Well, okay. I need a tune-up fast.
You'll get right on it. Be sure. Let's get this thing on the lift.
Oh, no!
Seems to be a problem. You're right, teacher. You need a tune-up as well. Just one minor adjustment. There! She's tuned up perfectly now.
Sounds good.
Gee, that was great, Rolf.
Yeah, you win for sure.
I'll call Nanny and have her mail it in.
Hold it! What are you all looking so gloomy about? I thought you liked my song.
Your song was great, Rolf. It's just that, well, we'd like to write songs like you, too.
Yeah, you have more musical talent in your little toe than we have all put together.
Speak for yourself, Piggy. Personally, my body has lots of musical talent. Whoa! See what I mean?
What's the matter with you guys? We've played music together lots of times. You're all good enough to write songs.
No way!
I'll prove it to you.
Really? Maybe we could.
I'll try if you try.
Gee, maybe we could write a song together, Piggy.
Oh, I'd love to write a song with you, Kermie. And I could sing it like Piggy Parton. Oh, Kermie, we've got to come up with a hit song for my big concert.
Well, let's see.
Oh, no! All of my fans are waiting and I don't have a song to sing.
How about this one, Piggy? Frog, froggy in the swamp. Where mosquitoes and fireflies romp. Where if you're a toad, you stay out of the road. 'Cause the cars that go by, they don't honk.
I don't quite know how to tell you this, Kermit, but on a scale of 1 to 10, that song was minus 12! It's horrible!
Gee, I didn't think my song was that bad. Did you? I can't let Piggy go on stage without a good song to sing. There's only one thing to do. Us struggling songwriters can't afford taxis. I sure hope she's home.
Well, if it isn't Kermit Kristofferson, what can I do for you?
I was wondering if you could do me a teensy-weensy favor, ma'am. You see, I need help writing a song for my friend Piggy.
Why, sure. I always was a sucker for little green guys. Come on in, Kermit.
Thanks.
You're on in 15 seconds, Piggy.
Oh, dear. And I still don't have a song to sing. My career will be ruined.
I've got a song, Piggy.
No, wait, Kermit. I'm not going out there and making a fool out of myself with one of your cornball songs. Nothing you could do would make me sing this song. The last time I said... Aha, there, everybody. give me that. I have a great little song here I'd like to sing for you.
This better be good, Frog.
Hit it, Phyllis.
It's hard to be a pig out on the prairie.
It's tough to be a frog out on the plains.
What?
Well, someday this cute frog and I will marry you.
Huh?
Then this cow pig's life won't be so strange.
We'll feel the little frog pig home on the range.
Yoo-hoo!
Wow, that was terrific!
Thank you! Thank you!
My turn! I'm gonna do a funny song! This is Fuzzy Bear, and my song is called How to Tell Chicken Jokes Without Laying an Egg! Hit it, guys! Waka waka waka! Fuzzy Bear's gonna talk! Why did the chicken cross the road? To try to find a ride? No! The chicken crossed the road, of course, to get to the other side! Wow! You might ask why a fireman would wear his red suspenders. The answer was quite plain to see. To keep his pants up. Oh, no. I bet you always wondered why elephants have trunks. When the weather's hot, they run to the beach and like to go for a dunk. Hey, don't you guys throw anything besides tomatoes? Sorry I asked.
Got a secret treasure to keep safe? You can keep it in a keeper.
Keepers, keepers, what's inside those keepers?
Fancy the Snail, Tango the Ladybug, and Sheldon the Turtle are keepers. Fun friends with a secret hiding place, each sold separately. And each keeper comes with its own finder, Twist, Nightlight, and Footloose.
Keepers, keepers, keeps it safe inside.
Fancy and Footloose, Tango and Twist, Sheldon and Nightlight, each sold separately with Brush Key and Storybook from Tonka.
Scared silly, starring Ronald McDonald and the Chicken McNuggets.
Ronald, nice to see you in this neck of the woods. Come on.
What are you making?
We're stirring up secret sauces.
For dipping.
We ready, boss?
Let's make sauce.
Oh, well, at least I got my hair done.
I have an idea.
Whoop-de-doo, McDonald's sauces.
You can always count on them to be terrific.
It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
Where are you going with those stripes?
That's Aqua Fresh for kids. Just follow me.
Toothpaste? I hate to brush.
Aqua Fresh for kids makes brushing fun. It's got a zingy taste kids love. Fluoride, too, and it's easy to pump and has a neat top.
Great, but how are you going to get those stripes in there?
Watch. Aqua Fresh for kids. I make brushing fun.
That's the end of my funny song. Thank you very much. Pretty good, huh?
Sure, Fuzzy. That was, wasn't it, guys?
I'm glad you liked it.
Who's next?
Why don't you give it a try, Scooter?
Gosh, I've never written a song before.
You've written a computer program, haven't you?
Yeah, but what's that got to do with music?
Lots of music is written on computers, Scooter.
Yeah, you're right.
We're recording.
My name is Scooter, and this song is called, Computer Scooter. Huh? Gee, something doesn't sound right. Maybe there's something wrong with my computer. We'd better take a look.
What are we looking for, Scooter?
We're looking for the RAM.
There he is.
Not that kind of RAM, Fozzie. R-A-M. Random Access Memory.
Oh.
It's where my music program is stored.
I know that.
Here it is.
I don't see any music in here, Scooter. Only these electronic thingies.
Yeah, like what's going on, man?
Ew! Electronic monsters!
Hey, don't get yourself all frazzled. We're just electronic musicians.
I've been looking all over for you guys.
Sorry, man. We've been taking five. Bites, that is. You know, like in, computer bites?
I'm writing some electronic music, and I need your help.
You got it, Computer Scooter. One, two, three, four.
Thanks, guys.
That was great, Scooter.
Yeah, I guess I can write songs, huh?
Now it's my turn, and I know exactly what kind of song I'm gonna write. A marching song. Come on, guys. Get your instruments and follow me. Wasn't that great? I just love March songs.
Personally, I prefer April songs. Get it? March, April, waka waka waka!
Funny, funny!
Thanks, animal.
I'm gonna write a rock song, but first I need a rock band.
I'll be in your band, Gonzo.
Don't be silly. You can't be in my rock band, Kermit.
Why not?
Because you're not a rock.
Huh?
Okay, fellas, we got a song to do. Let's try that one more time from the top. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four. What's wrong with you guys? You're supposed to be rock musicians. You haven't played a note all day. Leroy, what happened to that great beat you're famous for, huh? And Bruce, baby, what's your problem? Why aren't you guys playing? Is it something I said? Don't I pay you enough? What was that? Of course! How could I have been so stupid? I remembered the rocks, but I forgot the rules! You know what to do, girls! This is Gonzo's Rock and Roll Band! Take one! One! Two, one, two, three, four. Weirdo that you are. Weirdo that you are. But if you get too weird, your face looks like a troll. Take five.
I think it's our turn, Beaker. Sure, you can play music, Beaker. All you need is my latest invention. The Bunsen Honeydew solar-powered one-man band. Don't worry, Beaker. It's easy. Ready?
Ready, Bunsen.
A one, a two, a...
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's too bad, Bunsen. I guess you and Beaker won't be able to enter the contest now.
Of course we will. I still have this.
A ping-pong ball?
No, it's my Bunsen Honeydew self-propelled follow the bouncing ball ball.
How does it work?
Simple. Watch. Go on, Beaker. Think.
That was amazing, Bunsen. And you too, Beaker.
Thanks.
Well, we've all written our songs. It's time to send in the tape and...
Me song! Me song!
Don't be silly, animal. You can't even talk right. How are you going to write a song?
Not right. Drum!
What?
That was wild, animal.
Yeah.
I'll shut the tape recorder off. Don't worry. I'll have it straightened out in 2 minutes. Oh, boy. How about 2 years?
Now we'll never know if we won the song contest.
Wait a minute. There's still a chance to enter our songs. All we have to do is put the tape back together and wind it back on the cassette.
I'll get the mending tape.
Now we just have to untangle this mess.
Hey, watch it, Kermit.
Then we wind it back into the cassette. There, good as new.
How did your song come out, Rolf?
Great, Nanny.
We all wrote songs.
You did?
Uh-huh. Here they are, Nanny.
Thank you, Kermit. I'll mail this off right away.
Oh, boy! I can't wait to see if we win!
You're right, Beaker. A week is an awfully long time to wait. Tastes good!
Hurry, Nanny! The winning song is going to be played any second!
I think this is the station.
And now it's time to play the winning song in the Tiny Way Piano Songwriters Contest.
That's your song, Rolf.
I won!
Wow!
Waka, waka, waka! Why did you game across the road?
You run home.
Was that all our songs?
That wild and crazy song was written by not one, but 10 creative little songwriters. The Muppet Babies. Way to go, kids. And thanks from the Tiny Way Piano Company.
We did it!
Yay!
That was a wonderful song, kids. I'm very proud of you.
I want to write another song.
Me too.
Good song.
Muppet Babies will return after these messages.
She's moving.
doing? It's Magic Muse Barbie.
Way girl, love the spotlight. Right, Barbie?
Magic Muse Barbie.
Little gown with sparkle and shine.
We turn and pose.
Divine.
Then move around that fabulous store. Everywhere we move, we steal the show. We girls can do anything. Right, Barbie?
Magic Muse Barbie doll comes with this three-piece outfit and change-around stole. New from Mattel.
Done at last.
Well, geez, how about some M&M's?
Hi, kids.
Wow.
Where M&M's chocolate candies go, there's bound to be some fun, you know. It's a bright and colorful wonderland. All the world loves M&M's. Pure milk chocolate's joy for everyone.
M&M's chocolate candies. The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
See you later.
Constructs!
You build
the alien.
You build
the Star Force.
Sold separately.
Challenge
the alien.
Hooray!
The Star Force.
They glow!
Constructs.
Star Force command set and alien battle strike set with pieces that glow in the dark. Sold separately.
Constructs!
Get up and catch the dad's fever with Pee-wee Herman.
I love my Muppets to brush my teeth.
Muppet fluoride toothpaste and toothbrushes from Oral-B.
I got a half pop!
Corn pops popping, popping in my head like popcorn popping, or popping in my head. Tell us corn pops popping, it's all I think about. Pop, pop, popping, they keep popping in my head. Corn pops popping, gotta get a taste, I can't stop popping. Corn pops popping, popping in my head.
Kellogg's Corn Pops. You can't stop thinking about that sweet popcorn taste. Part of this complete breakfast.
Corn pops popping, popping in my head.
And now, these messages.
5 minutes, Mr. Mouse.
Oh, good morning, boys and girls.
Woohoo, Pee-wee.
Ah! Oh, it's you, Countess.
What's today's secret word?
Perfect timing. I was just about to go ask Coggy.
Conky 2000, ready to assist you, Pee-wee.
Good morning, Conky. The Countess and I would like to know what today's secret word is. Today's secret word is... How? Now, you all remember what to do whenever anyone says the secret word, right?
Scream!
That's right!
For the rest of the day, whenever anyone says the secret word, scream real loud! Ready?
Let's try it. Oh, Countess!
Yes, Pee-wee?
You know the proper way to make ice cream?
Well, I'm a cow. Of course I know how.
Well, would you show me how?
I will.
Well, go ahead, magic screen.
Everyone loves ice cream, one of America's favorite delicacies. Let's take a trip to find out just how ice cream is made. It begins with milk, and we all know that milk comes from cows. Let's look in on Mr. Dairy Farmer getting ready to milk the cows. An automatic milking machine is attached to the cow, allowing the milk to travel to a storage tank. Next, sugar, egg yolks, whipping cream, flavoring, and fruit are mixed into the milk. Then it's ready to be made into delicious ice cream cups, cones, and bars. Looks good, doesn't it? The final step is to package the ice cream and send it off to the store so everyone can enjoy it. Hey, save some for me!
Ice cream! You scream! We all scream for ice cream!
And how? So long, Pee-wee!
Bye-bye, Countess! Let's go look through my microscope!
A microscope lets you look at things that you can't see with the naked eye!
Ah! Don't look at me! My eyes are naked!
I'm looking at a tiny drop of water that I got out of the fish tank.
Wow! Ooh!
Gosh, I never knew there was so much going on inside a drop of water!
Chloe,
what are you reading?
The newspaper. You know, Pee-wee, a newspaper is a great way to find out what's happening.
What does it say about me?
What does it say about me?
What about me?
Sorry, everybody. There's nothing in it about the Playhouse.
That gives me a great idea, Globy. Why don't we start a Playhouse newspaper?
And everyone here can help write stories.
Yeah.
Pee-wee, a Playhouse newspaper sounds like fun.
If you ask me, a newspaper sounds like a dumb idea.
It isn't a dumb idea, Randy. A newspaper for the Playhouse will let us all know what's going on. We can stay informed. Exchange ideas.
The only thing a newspaper is good for is to rat fish in.
Uh-oh. In that case, no news is good news.
You're gonna see, Randy. This is going to be the best Playhouse newspaper the Playhouse has ever had. Ace reporter, Pee Wee Herman, on the scene. Now all I need is some news.
Remember, Pee Wee, every good news story has the 5 W's and the H.
The 5 W's and the H? What's that, Globy?
Who, what, when, where, why, and how.
Pee Wee will return after these messages. We're in the wild shape! We're the stars and going to the beach! And we're big time into California Dream Barbie.
California Dream Barbie's into fashion fun. She's into changing to bikinis in the California sun. She's into taking shots.
Palm tree earrings.
She's into laughing a lot. You know we're into it too. We just can't stop.
We're into Barbie.
California Dream Barbie doll comes with a Beach Boys record for you. Surf and shop and dolls all sold separately. From Mattel.
Wake up to the hot taste of Kellogg's Pop Tarts.
So hot.
Real fruit fillings give Pop-Tarts an incredible taste. So hot, they're cool.
Hot taste, so cool.
Hot. Now in Pop-Tarts' new family pack, free binoculars.
Cool.
I want to see.
Whoa.
I want to see.
Sure. See?
Free in Pop-Tarts.
Thanks for helping put away our dinosaur collection, Ronald.
You're welcome. There, the box is full.
Got room in there for one more?
Well, I guess so.
Okay, Spock, jump in.
When you get an on-the-go Happy Meal box, you could carry your ape, 12 tapes, or a man made of blocks. When you get an on-the-go Happy Meal bag, you could carry your puppet, a trumpet, or a silly gag. One on-the-go box or bag with every Happy Meal you buy at McDonald's. You can collect all four.
Hey, Vern, it's Ernest.
He's so crazy.
Know what I mean?
Starting September 17th, it's gonna be wild.
When Saturday rocks on CBS.
And now, back to Pee-wee's Playhouse.
Yeah!
And now, these messages.
5 minutes, Mr. Mouse.
Still no dogs here. Got it!
Hey, Pee-wee. Here comes the most beautiful woman in Puppet Land.
Why, that can only be one person, Miss Yvonne! Hi, Miss Yvonne!
Hi, Pee-wee! Hi, everyone!
Hi, Miss Yvonne!
Hi, boys and girls!
That's a beautiful scarf, Miss Yvonne! Hold it!
Thank you! It's for my story for the fashion page of the Playhouse Press. The scarf. The accessory that does everything.
It does?
Sure it does. Just watch. It's a belt.
Hold it.
Wear it on your shoulder. And it's a tasteful fashion statement.
Hold that.
Now, it's a babushka.
Ooh, ooh. Hold that. Beautiful. Hold that.
Ooh. Tie it around your neck, and it's a neckerchief.
A little more eyes.
It up over your face and you're a bandit. Stick him up, big guy.
Ooh, ooh. Miss Fogg, do you think I could possibly interview you for the Playhouse paper?
Well,
come on, Miss Fogg, please, please, please. Pretty please with sugar on top.
Well, as long as you put it that way.
Okay. Question number one.
When did you discover that you were so beautiful?
The first time I looked in a mirror.
Is it fun being so beautiful?
Oh, yes. Beauty. Beauty is my life. But sometimes, it's a lot of hard work.
It is?
Mm-hmm. Pee-wee, you're not gonna believe this. But sometimes, I just don't feel beautiful.
I don't believe it.
What do you do?
I just don't look in the mirror.
Okay, now, on a more personal level.
You know, I'd love to stay here and answer your questions, Pee-wee, but a gal's got to keep the guys guessing about some things. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Boy, this is going to be a great story.
Hey, Pee-wee. Pee-wee. My story's ready.
Oh, good.
Thanks, Bobby.
Pee-wee, my story's ready, too.
Oh, thanks, Terry.
And here's the rest.
Oh, good.
Thanks, Conky.
Boy.
Everybody did a great job. All deserve a reward. Snack time!
Hooray!
Today for snack time, we're making trail mix.
It's easy to make.
And fun to eat.
I'm using raisins.
Peanuts. Sunflower seeds.
Almonds. Banana chips. Just like a banana, only crunchy. And my favorite, coconut shavings. Now, put the lid on and get ready to shake.
Voila!
Trail mix!
Delicious!
If I do
say so myself!
And I do.
Hey,
I wonder if the food page is ready yet. Pretty corny.
Hey, Pee-wee, it's time for a cartoon.
This is a tale of a little red hen, lived on a farm in a chicky chick pen. She and her brood would never shirk, but the live long day just work, work, work.
Not I. My feet are flat.
Not I. Go ask the cat.
Ah! I'll do it!
little red hen just looked around. Found a little plow to plow her ground. Plowed it hard and she plowed it deep. And the little chicks helped with the feet, feet, feet. So the little hen worked like a busy bee. She had to feed her family. Needed the dough and she needed it quick. For empty tummies make little chicks sick.
First edition of the Playhouse paper. This is gonna be the best newspaper the Playhouse has ever.
Well, looks like Pee-wee finished typing up the newspaper.
Tips, Globe's World Report. Boring. Nobody's gonna want to read this dull news. What this paper needs is a little excitement. Let's see. Ha! I've got it. This ought to spice it up.
What? Who says?
You do! Right here on page 3!
I didn't write that. The people of Iceland are very friendly.
Oh, Jumbie!
What is it, Terry?
May I have my two wishes, please?
Wishes? What wishes?
It says right here in your horoscope column, everyone gets two wishes today.
Wait a minute, that's not what I said.
Have you read the story about Miss Yvonne?
Do you think it's true?
It must be. It's in the newspaper.
Why did she do it? I thought she was our friend.
Who's responsible for this?
Miss Yvonne from the Playhouse.
I can't believe my eyes.
Yeah. She ain't no crook.
Oh, I just can't believe this. Why, these are all lies.
Hi, everybody. So, did you all enjoy the paper?
No!
I didn't say there were headhunters in Iceland.
But...
And you told everyone I'd give them two wishes.
But...
And why did you print this about me?
Miss Yvonne robs Playhouse!
You know it isn't true.
Gosh, everyone. I didn't write this.
Who did?
I did.
Randy, how could you?
Nice going.
Why, Randy?
Well, all your stories are real dull. So, when Pee-wee fell asleep last night, I fixed them up a little. They're not dull now, are they?
They're not true either, Randy. You can't just make up lies about people.
Especially in the newspaper.
Yeah.
You shouldn't tell lies, Randy.
You won't have any friends left if you don't tell the truth about them, Randy.
I was just trying to make the newspaper more exciting.
What's more important, the newspaper or your friends?
Yeah, what's more important?
Jeez, nothing's more important than my friends, I guess. Well, I'm sorry, everybody. I sort of got carried away. From now on, I'll always tell the truth.
Can I quote you on that?
Hey, everyone. There's one story in the paper that's still true.
Which one, Pee-wee?
The one on the last page.
It says here there's going to be a big dance at the Playhouse.
When?
Right now! Conky, start the music!
Trouble when you don't tell the truth.
Guess we all learned an important lesson today. And how?
Your bubble? Bubble Yum invites you to snap the fabulous bubbles you and your friends can blow with Bubble Yum Bubble Gum. The funniest, zaniest, most buffo bubble photo might win prizes like a VCR, limo ride, concert tickets, and over 2,000 cameras for runners-up. Want to show us your best Bubble Yum bubble?
Yum, yum, with Bubble Yum.
Details in September magazines on specially marked packs or right, Bubble P.O. Box 7300, Wilton, Connecticut.
We were on the trail of the Fruitosaurus. Look at the size of these tracks.
The legendary dinosaur that lived on sun-kissed bunsen.
We're getting close. I can smell it.
The dinosaur!
Bunsen dinosaur! Real fruit snacks from sun-kissed. He's friendly! They're the biggest bunsens you ever saw. Sun-kissed bunsen dinosaur!
And now back to Garfield and Friends.
Yeah!
And Friends will return after these messages.
Yeah!
This is the Kansas Broadcasting System.
Across this country for ice cream fun, America's favorite is 31. Baskin-Robbins. Sweet, sweet, Baskin-Robbins.
There's no sweeter treat in America than a frosty Baskin-Robbins Coke float for just 99 cents. Ice-cold Coca-Cola, together at last with your favorite ice cream flavor for a thirst-quenching float that really hits the spot. All for the sweet price of just 99 cents.
Oh, Baskin-Robbins, you're America's ice cream treat.
Our faces aren't gonna like this.
Get your lips! Come on out!
Hey! Come on, let's go! Pinch me! I think I'm dreaming!
What if my face wakes up?
It won't! Besides, man, Tang has vitamin C for the whole body! Natural flavor for us!
Wow!
Tang is incredible!
It's music to my lips! I can't believe
I like it!
Tang brand. The taste your mouth can't wait for.
Mine, oh mine!
You got the rhythm, so we use it.
Great taste.
Got the good times, the music.
Good time, great taste.
Getting into the rhythm of our race.
The good time, great taste.
Oh, McDonald's.
And now back to Garfield and Friends.
Yeah!
We'll return after these messages.
Yeah!
Meet the Pretenders. We're a bunch of cats who'll do anything to get out of this pet shop, even dress up like other animals. So if you see us in your neighborhood, and you find out we're not what you think we are...
You're the best bunny ever.
You're not a bunny. You're a cat. Don't tell, okay?
Don't worry. It'll be our secret.
The Pretenders from Fisher-Price, each sold separately. Squeeze them, and they really purr.
Details on specially marked M&M's packages for the 60 Years with Mickey game.
I gotta have pop!
Corn pop, poppin', poppin' in my head like popcorn, poppin', poppin' in my head. Corn pop, poppin', it's all I think about. Pop, pop, poppin', Mickey poppin' in my head. Corn pop, poppin', gotta get a taste, I can't stop poppin'. Corn pop, poppin', poppin' in my head.
Kellogg's Corn Pops. You can't stop thinking about that sweet corn taste. Part of this complete breakfast.
Corn pop, poppin', poppin' in my head.
Pop. And now back to Garfield and Friends.
Yeah!
Message.
Who tried to bite a Chips Ahoy cookie without biting a chip?
I'll reconstruct the crime. Snack time. Someone spies a playful of Chips Ahoy cookies. He bites a chip. He tries again, but the chips are stacked against him.
Original, chewy, and striped Chips Ahoy.
I confess, I did it, and I'll do it again.
Did you bite a chip?
Good time, great taste, every time spot.
Good time, sizzle all around town.
Great shake,
coming up Sundays, cooling down.
Good time,
moving through the beat of the summer heat.
Hot strike,
Coca-Cola, cool down to your feet.
Good time, ooh, great taste.
Summertime, this is my place.
Yeah. Good time, great taste.
Of McDonald's, summertime,
sizzle hot.
Beep-bop, McDonald's, summertime,
sizzle hot.
Beep-bop, McDonald's.
Gonna party!
Yeah, yeah.
Right here on CBS.
Oh, hi, Vern. I was just dreaming about the joys of doggy ownership. You know, the pitter-patter of furry feet, a cold, wet, friendly nose on your cheek. And I've got everything I need, Vern. I got a bone and a collar and a leash. The only thing I don't have is a dog. But it can't just be any dog, Vern. It's got to be Rover, my dream dog. It's got to have furry, fuzzy little long ears and a nose on one end and a tail on the other. And Vern, I can teach him to bring in the paper and to bring home a carton of milk when he comes. The only thing is, Vern, where am I going to get $100? Stay right here, Vern. I've got an idea.
Hey, Vern, today's your lucky day. We knew you wouldn't want to oversleep, Vern. We only do it once a week, Vern. Me and all the other guys, Vern.
We even brought the pies, Vern.
It's the Ernest P. Moore with a story and a moral and a big chuckle, hip trip, double dip, super supreme show. You know what I mean? No! Hey, Vern, we moved your furniture and now we're gonna fire up the barbecue, Vern. We owe it all to you, Vern. But now you gotta move, Vern!
Hey, Vern!
Hey, Vern!
Hey, Vern, it's me! I'm on TV!
Hey, Vern, it's Ernest. We'll return after these messages.
Lost?
Yeah, I've been adrift for days. I'm tired of frozen breakfasts. Yuck.
Then follow my snoot to flavors of fruit.
Fruit?
Follow my nose.
I'm on your tail. Whoa!
It always knows.
Whoa!
Kellogg's Fruit Loop Cereal. With natural orange, lemon, and cherry flavors, and lots of vitamin C, part of this complete breakfast. Like them?
Yeah. They're cool.
Win this one, and there's Nestle Quick for everyone.
Quick? Nestle Quick? So chocolatey, so rich and thick, I gotta have you, Nestle Quick! Yeah!
It works every time.
Nestle Quick, the taste that gets you going.
And now, back to Hey Vern, it's Ernest.
Yeah! Hey Vern, it's Pets. Oh, hi, Vern. Vern, I finally figured out how to make enough money to buy a Rover. You're going to love this idea, Vern. The Ernest P. World Pet Daycare Center. Oh, let's see. Just tying to the TV for right now. Business is booming, Vern. I hope you didn't mind me using your living room. It's only for a couple of days. Reptiles in the kitchen. Vern, would you mind keeping a family of rats in your bedroom?
Ernest, running a pet daycare center? He couldn't run water if his hands were taped to a faucet.
Watch your fingers, George. Oh, hi. I'm Mac, and that's my roommate, George. Yep, you guessed it. George is building a cage. Now, I've never been one to like pets around the house, but you know how George can be when it comes to getting what he wants. So now it's just a matter of time. George calls it fun, but I call it more work for me. Well, he seems pretty serious. I wonder what kind of pet he's gonna get.
Oh, thank heavens, what a day. My husband ran over the weed eater, my kids got into the garbage. I'm late for my belly dancing class, and my bird sitter called and canceled at the last minute. I saw your pet daycare sign, Ernest. Is there room for Cochise today? He's really a very good bird, except, of course, that he doesn't talk. In fact, if you teach Cochise to talk, I'll give you an extra $25. Make that
$50. $50? Come on, Cochise. Come on. Come on. Cochise, come on, Cochise, let's talk. Cochise, let's talk.
There's another mistake parents are making these days. Teaching their children to talk.
Hi, I'm Chuck. I just said hi, I'm Chuck in dog talk. I can talk dog talk. That's Bobby. I just called him Ricky. He can't talk dog talk, so he doesn't know. Bobby here is using the old-fashioned way, a net. You catch fish in a net. You don't get dogs in a net. I use my brain. I know how to get dogs with dog talk. And watch this. I'm going to tell this dog a joke.
It's the Bill and Coo Show.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Got a real sad song for you today.
Real sad. Goes like this.
Now I've known Jerome since he was a puppy. He's not one to stray far from home.
He dipped over the trash and I acted too rash. Now it's
3 days since I've seen Jerome. Won't you please come home? You can eat at the table, have a steak on your own.
Jerome,
won't you please come home?
I love you, Coo.
Love you, Bill.
Bye.
First we add an ear, some paws, a couple of waggy tails, and Viola. Eureka, California! I've done it. I've developed my dream pet. The worst dog in the world. He comes when you call him, always bites you when you pet him, and never messes on the outside.
Is the name, and Pet Portraits is the game. Today we're taking pet portraits of Mrs. Waxman's pet alligators. You ready, guys? Hold it. You're gonna like this one. That's a good boy.
Oh, look at this. Oh, Garfield is blue. Oh, let's see.
Yeah. Good morning, Earl.
Oh, hey, Ernest. Trying to get a good picture here. Oh, whoop. Yeah, all.
Perfect.
Oh, yeah, got it. Thank you, Ernest. Boy, you sure are shaggy, Ernest. Why don't you have a seat right here? Let me lower those ears. Come on, have a seat here. You feel better and you look spiffy.
Okay, Earl, just a little bit off the top. See, I'm starting my own business.
Oh, really?
I got a pet daycare center. Huh? Because I'm going to buy myself a dog. Oh. So make me look like a Wall Street tycoon.
All righty.
That's it. A Wall Street tycoon.
All right, well, you just hold real still now. Relax. Let old Earl just get that... Hold still. Hold still. That's the hard part. The hard part's over now. Alrighty, Ernest, there you go. Take a look. Tell me what you think, huh? Huh?
Wah! Earl, this doesn't look like a Wall Street tycoon.
Oh, silly me. Well, I thought you said a deadbeat raccoon. Huh? But what do you think? Do you like it?
It could work.
You like the tail up or to the side?
No, up.
Up, yeah, it's going to take a lot of moves.
Existo, the magician.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome! It is indeed an honor and a privilege for me to be performing for you today. I, of course, am Existo, the remarkable. And today, I will make a raccoon just disappear like magic, which, of course, is what I do. Magic. First, I take the raccoon like so, and then I take the little scarf, and I hold it out like so, and the magic words, hotsy, totsy, rigmarole, lasagna. And yes, it disappeared. I swear to you, it's gone. Honest. And now it's back. Yes. Thank you! Thank you!
Yo, hey, I'm Ernest Tubb. You know, you really should take good care of your pets. I mean, you gotta feed them and water them, and you should play. Oh no! Oh no, Ernest! I don't believe you're doing this. Oh gosh, cat hair! I can't stand it when he bathes his cat.
Well, it's feeding time again in old Montana.
Oh, hey, Vern, jump down.
You're just in time to help me feed all my little pets. You know, Vern, I made up some sandwiches, but it's so hard to figure out what to feed these little ones nowadays. Let's see. Who got the ham and Swiss on rye? You?
You're welcome.
And who got the roast beef and cheddar on whole wheat? Go. And who got the turkey and tomato on Swiss?
Mom?
Go.
And here's one. Liver, sardine, and onions. I guess the liver, sardine, and onions is mine, Vern.
My father, the clown.
Is that music absolutely necessary?
Eddie, you wearing your pajamas to school today?
It's better than what he usually wears.
Whoa!
I'm not going to school today.
Aren't you feeling well, Eddie?
Everybody likes Skeeter. I don't have any friends.
Oh, sure you do.
You've been wearing those big floppy shoes they bought you?
Everybody laughed at me.
Well, of course they did. That's the whole idea, son. Hey, what's the magic word?
Oh, Dad.
Honey, if he doesn't feel
What's the magic word?
A glass of milk, a loaf of bread,
a bowl of cereal on your head.
Whoa! Come on, coaches. I've got $50 riding on this game. When are you going to get off the mark and start talking? Come on. Am I communicating here? Am I piercing the void? Or am I just talking to myself? Or am I craving a big, fat, juicy drumstick?
Ernest, you're such a bird brain. That parrot will teach you to fly before you teach it to talk.
Hey, Vern. You're just in time for nap time at the Ernest P. World Daycare Pet Center. I'm going to read him a little story. Okay, all you critters settle in now. Once upon a time, there was a little dog named Rover who lived in a pet store. And not far away, in the same town, was a person who loved Rover very much. And Rover dreamed about this person every night, and this person dreamed about Rover. The only problem was, Rover cost $100, and this person didn't have $100. So, look, Vern, they all fell asleep just when I was getting to the good part.
Isn't that cute?
Anyway, this guy didn't have $100. So he went to the pet store and he told the man.
Hey, Vern, it's Ernest. We'll return after these messages.
Christmas candy makes mouths happy.
Mouth
of
any
make
good to eat.
Strawberry flavored, a juicy treat. Twist a man a coil. Twist, tie a man in the
eat him bite by bite by bite.
Chew, chewy, chew.
Twistlers candy.
Lots in every pack.
Twistlers.
Twistlers makes mouth happy.
Oh, 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 who's that Twister? Who's that Cruncher? It's Oreo action, for Oreo muncher. Be a licker, a cruncher, a chocolate cookie dunker, a creamy middle muncher, with O-R-E-O.
Oreo action,
Oreo action. Twister, dunker. step, whatever your attraction. While zero on your action, O-R-E-O.
The Disco.
Are you gonna brave the rapids?
Sure, after this complete breakfast, including my frosted flakes, they bring out the tiger in you.
Good, you'll need it.
Good, they're great.
You'll show them you're a tiger. Show them what you can do. The taste of Tony's frosted flakes.
Wow.
Bring out the tiger in you.
You can get a frisbee fly
really?
And amaze your
wow.
friends with your virtuosity.
Virtuosity?
Even with friends as dumb as mine. One free frosted flakes.
And now, back to Hey Vern, it's Ernest.
Yeah! Hey Vern, my pet daycare center's going real well, but the ducks have locked themselves in the other bathroom. So I was wondering if you'd mind watching these water snakes for me. Vern, they've already had lunch. Nap time is 2 o'clock, and please, don't let them play stickball in the street. Know what I mean?
Yeah, I tried to take a bath once, but I couldn't handle it. I was all washed up. I came completely apart.
Boy, sure is hot today, ain't that right, Bobby? Whew, what a job. We've been chasing these dogs all day and haven't even caught the first one. It's better work this trolling for dogs. There was a school of them around here. Whoa! Hey, hang on a minute. I got one! I bet he weighs 200 pounds. He weighs an ounce. I lost it. Took the bait. Well, let's go get some more cats.
Hey kids, it's time for Lonnie Dunn's School of Hollywood Sound Effects. Hey kids, did you hear that? Boy, I sure did. Hey, you know what we're going to learn today? The sound effects from my latest motion picture called The Gerbils Are Coming, The Gerbils Are Coming. And it's the sound of a pet gerbil yodeling. It's done very simply. You apply the meaty part of your hand to your jowl, wrap your fingers around your face, and blow. See you next week, yes, and don't forget.
It's true, Mr. Cochise. You have the right to remain silent. But may I remind you, we have ways of making you talk. Know what I mean? Vern, I know you're not supposed to count your chickens before they hatch, but what do you do, Vern? If they're already numbered.
Bobby! Here, Bobby! Bobby, we gotta do something different. I'm gonna try something. I'm gonna use dog talk, and I'm gonna say sirloin steak. If I can remember how it goes. I got it. No, that's pie. Some kind of pie, pecan pie. Sirloin is a. Oh, I got it. They ought to be here any minute.
It worked. More pressure, Fido. More pressure.
My mom and daddy said it was raising cats and dogs. I guess that's why my mama doesn't like for me to play in poodles. Boy, grown-ups, your talk, buddy. Know what I mean?
Pets. They're supposed to be companions. All they do is cause commotion. Take my dog, Korak. Bless his little heart. You let him out, he wants in. You let him in, he wants out. You go to feed him. He's not hungry.
dogs. Man's best friend. Wouldn't you know it, I'm a woman. I don't apply.
Woody, if you don't start being nice, I'm going to put you up in a tree and call in the woodpeckers.
Okay, I'll be nice.
Woody, what would you like to do today?
Today, I'd like to start out by giving my friend, you, a little present.
Oh, yeah? What?
Splinters.
Ow! Stop with the yellow!
I had a splinter once. It was so big it had a name. My son, God bless him, had to pull it out with a tow truck.
Well, it didn't work. None of the dogs came. Maybe I lied about dog talk. Maybe you should have just said something simple like, "Here, boy! Here, boy!"
Untie the tongue, unzip the lip, or I will give the bird a flip. Comprendo, deja vu?
I was framed, I tell you. I was framed. I want to see the warden. I am Woody. I'm not an animal. Let me out of here. Let me out.
Hey, Vern. You know, Vern, not only am I making money, but I'm also learning an awful lot from running a pet daycare center. You know, I can't wait to teach Rover everything I've learned here. As it turns out, Vern, I am a natural-born animal trainer. Watch this. Here's one I just taught Buster today. Here, Buster. Did you ever see an elephant catch a frisbee in his teeth like that? Amazing animals, know what I mean?
Well, I sure am glad George finally decided to feed his new pet. Yeah, for a minute there, I was beginning to wonder if he was ever going to fix me something to eat. Oh, thanks, George, my very, very favorite. You know, sometimes being a pet's not all bad. Hey, George, if I finish all my lunch, can we please go for a walk later? Please? Please?
Yeah, I just flew in from Vegas, and boy, are my wings tired. Hey, where are you from? What's your name? Are these too hard for you? Come on, help me out. I'm winging it here. Come on, I'm laying an egg. Hey, did you hear about the bird that walks into the Chinese restaurant and orders tweets and tower sauce?
Just a minute. What a turkey.
You know, unlike us humans, dogs can't brush their teeth or floss. They have to chew things to clean their teeth. That's why you should always make sure your dog has a chew toy.
You can't do this to me. That's your real dog.
Be quiet.
What are you doing?
You're going to be great friends, trust me.
You can't throw
that. Oh, yes,
that's a real dog out there.
You'll like him, Woody. No, you will like him. He's very gentle, really. For a Rottweiler. Woody's a nice boy.
Hello! Have you two had fun today?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've had fun. We haven't had a big chance to talk, but we've had a lot of fun.
Well, that's okay. I guess Cochise just isn't going to talk today. Thanks, Ernest.
Gosh, I guess I'll never get $50.
Hey, Bert, know what I mean? Brad, give him the 50. 96, 97, 98, 99, 100 smackaroos, Bert. Rover is nearly mine. I can already see that little tail wagging and that little tongue panting. Bert, Rover's gone. He's gone. Rover's been sold.
Gosh, Vern, Rover's gone. He's been sold. Now I'll never have my dream dog. I worked so hard, Vern, and now Rover's gone.
Rover!
Vern!
Rover. Vern. It's Rover. Vern, it's Rover. Oh, Rover. Oh. Thank you, Vern. Thank you. You're such a good friend to get Rover for me. Listen, Vern. Anything you want from now on, anything, you just ask it. Oh,
not so fast, Vern. We'll talk about this later. Come on, Rover.
Hey, Vern, it's Ernest. We'll return after these messages.
Jump on your boogie board, grab a stick of juicy fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy fruit is gonna move ya. It chews the salt, it gets right to ya. Juicy fruit, the taste is gonna move ya.
Get the beat! A is for apple.
Applejack, so apple-y sweet.
And you know, J is for Jack.
Real apples and cinnamon make Kellogg's Apple Jacks an apple-y sweet part of a complete breakfast.
Applejack's a day, apple-y sweet. Applejack!
Why don't we do breakfast?
You can collect a different cool flute section free in Applejack's, Honey Smacks, and Corn Pops.
And now, back to Hey Vern, it's Ernest.
Okay, it's time for Flip.
About time for you to leave, Hamilton. I'm sick of the nonsense.
George, take a hike. Today, we're going to find out why singer Stacey Q wanted to fight back. Star Trekking actor Will Wheaton takes us on a stomach-turning day off. And focus your eyes on the darker side of glasses. Take off into the stratosphere with the hottest thing on four wheels and rad ways to fake out your parents.
This could very well be my final performance.
George, it's Flip.
Flip for return after these messages.
What a great day for singing our new song.
Good time, good time. Great taste, great taste. That's why this is our place.
Our place.
The good time, great taste of McDonald's.
Good time, great taste. That's why this is our place.
The good time, great taste of McDonald's. Good time, great taste.
McDonald's.
Here's the spot.
Good time, great taste. That's why this is our place. Good time, great taste. Of McDonald's. McDonald's. Good time, great taste. Of McDonald's.
Wake up to the hot taste of Kellogg's Pop-Tarts.
So hot.
And cool.
So cool.
And fast.
And you'll be the first to know.
Hot, 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 hot.
Real fruit fillings give Pop-Tarts an incredible taste. So hot, they're cool.
Pop-Tarts
so cool.
Now in Pop-Tart's new family pack, free binoculars.
Cool.
I want to see.
Wow.
I want to see.
Sure.
See?
Free in Pop-Tarts.
Right here on CBS.
sir. I'd like to rent this videotape, please.
What is it?
Cartoon favorites.
I don't feel like renting it to you.
Why not?
Because I hate the thought of you sitting in front of your television, laughing and having a good time, okay?
But that's not fair.
You're right. That's not fair.
Who is that guy?
My identity is none of your concern. What should be your concern now, mister, is that you are legally obligated to rent tapes to any customer able to pay.
I'll rent to anybody I want, you half-sized secret agent in a trench coat.
I'd advise against your behavior. Besides, name-calling belittles your character.
And what are you gonna do about it, you low-statured pain in the neck? Hey, what?
Why, you little...
Thanks for helping me.
I hope you enjoy the tape.
How can I thank you for saving me from that mean clerk?
No need to thank me. Just remember, use your VCR for quality programs. Television should be used for good and not evil.
Hey, you guys, I got a new hobby. I'm practicing juggling. I'm gonna be the best in the world.
You're already the best in the world at annoying me, and you don't even need to practice.
How come surfers wear that rubber clothing in the water?
Oh, maybe it's in case an electric eel touches them.
You know, I'm going to be the best baseball pitcher that ever lived. Or should I be a football quarterback? Maybe I'll have to do it all.
I can't believe these guys with the useless skills, and people give them money. Who cares if you can stand on your head for 3 hours?
Oh, it doesn't matter how good you are at something. It just matters how hard you try.
Get out of here.
Even people who love potato chips are surprised at how good Keebler's new Old Boise's taste.
Oh! Old Boise's are old boisterous.
They're bubbly, crackly, roisterous.
So full of my whole potato taste. Old Boise's are old boisterous.
New from the Keebler elves, Old Boise's potato snack chips in original and sour cream and onion. So bubbly, crackly, so Idaho potato-y, you'll say...
Glorious, notorious, delicious, and uproarious. They're Keebler's new Old Boise's and...
Old Boise's are old boisterous.
Keeps the kids off the street.
Now I have a lot more friends than I did.
I love it.
Kids need the Boys Club. We need your help.
Win this one, and there's Nestle Quick for everyone.
Quick? Nestle Quick? So chocolatey, so rich and thick, I gotta have you, Nestle Quick! Yeah!
It works every time.
Nestle Quick, the taste that gets you going.
Good times, great taste. The good time, great taste of McDonald's.
With the McDonald's Happy Meal, I always have a whale of a time.
On-the-go Happy Meal comes in a bag or a box. There's a picture on the bag, stickers for the box. You can take them anywhere, all around the clock. Carry things, too. Carry things, pro. That's why we call them on-the-go. On-the-go Happy Meal, only at McDonald's.
Mighty Mouse!
Here I come to save the day.
It's superhero action and excitement.
When Saturday rocks on CBS.
Zoom, 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 boom, 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 boom.
Here he comes, that mighty mouse, coming to vanquish the foe with a mighty blow. So don't be afraid anymore,
'cause things won't be like they've been before.
Here I come to save the day.
Thank goodness Mighty Mouse is on his way.
So let the trumpet players play,
for Mighty Mouse is here today.
Here he comes, that Mighty Mouse, just like a bolt from the blue, with a heart that's true, fighting evil, fighting crime,
and always there in the nick of time.
Here he comes to save the day,
and he will prove that crime will never pay.
So let the trumpet players play,
for Mighty Mouse is here today.
And now, these messages.
Some things go great together, like the honey and crunch of golden grahams.
Oh, that good sweet honey and graham crackers.
like a crunch of golden brown.
Together!
We're together part of a complete breakfast.
Happy together.
Right now, every specially marked package of Golden Grahams is bursting with Starburst fruit chews in new tropical flavors, free inside.
Introducing Pocket Rockers. Tiny tapes, tiny players.
Down on the corner, out in the street, Pocket Rockers are playing. Where the music feels the beat.
Pocket Rockers. Play them here. Wear them anywhere.
Down on the corner, in the street, Pocket Rockers playing, where the music feels the beat.
Tiny players, tiny tapes, Pocket Rockers, tapes and accessories sold separately, batteries not included, from Fisher Price.
And now back to the new adventures of Mighty Mouse.
We're going to tell an imaginary story. You see, none of it ever happened. It's what we call a cautionary tale.
Oh, what a wonderful! Mother Mercy, there's a giant praying mantis, and it's got a squirt ball!
Oh, let's get out of here!
Someday. I'm hanging 10 on an anchovy. Help! Mighty Mouse!
That's enough horseplay for today, Bruno. I hear trouble. Here I come to save the day.
You got some loose ends to finish off?
But, Pearl, I... En garde! Had enough, huh? Don't want to play anymore, big guy, huh?
Hey, Bowerball! I hear people outside!
Shut up and give me back the soap.
Oh, look, it's Pearl, Pureheart, and Mighty Mouth. They seem to be arguing again.
You know, I always thought that those two should be together.
Hey, Sourpuss, I've got an idea. Why don't we play Cupid? I could work on Mighty Mouth.
And I'll convince Pearl. Listen, working together, this plan can't miss.
Now, don't you go tearing up Fossville again, pal. Now run along to Tokyo.
Hello, Mighty Mouse. Hey, isn't it about time you and Pearl got hitched?
Hello, Gandy. Married? Golly, I haven't really,
Well, you're always rescuing her, and the way you two argue... Well, it's pretty obvious to me and Sourpuss that you two are made for each other. Just like ketchup and cottage cheese.
Say, you're making me hungry, Gandy. Well, let's go in here for a quick bite, eh?
But, Sourpuss, the problem is I can't get Mighty to ever make a commitment. Ooh, sometimes he makes me so mad.
Say, Pearl, you look hungry. I know a swell joint nearby where we can get us some grub on a stick.
You double-crossed me.
So sue me. Go on, sit down.
My, that's certainly a big fish you have there.
It sure is. Want a bite?
No, thank you. Say, Mighty, isn't it time that two people like us who see so much of each other did something to make things official?
Golly, you mean we have to take out a business license?
No, you hyena! She means it's time you two got married.
Mighty, Mighty Mouse, this is your conscience speaking. Think carefully before you pop that question.
Hey, how come my conscience is James Hound? Don't I rate a cute cricket?
Mighty, pay attention. You gotta ask yourself, do I really want to be married? This is your decision, and it's your life. Just look at Pearl and say what comes from your heart.
Golly, Pearl, I'm trying to say, what I'm saying, Pearl, is that, will you marry me and I want to have your children?
And remember to get plenty of rest tonight, Mighty Mouse, because tomorrow you and Pearl elope to Vegas.
That's right, Sour Puss, and I'll be there to read the ceremony.
I won't forget. Good night, guys. I told you to watch that first step. Just think, tomorrow I'll be married. Married.
I forgot to buy all that cheese Pearl wanted.
Mighty, is that you? I hope you remembered the cheese for the weekend. My mother's coming.
Oh, no. My life is complete. What more do I need?
Hey, Mighty Boy, I'm... Mind if I come in?
You're in, Morton. Why not drop a load off your pouch?
Say, Moo, this here spiffy new lunchbox must have cost you a pretty penny. Moo. Say, I'm starved. Mighty, you sure don't have much to eat in there.
Well, that's the trouble, Morton. You see, I was supposed to buy all this food, cause Pearl's mother is coming for the weekend. But when I saw this beauty here, I just had to buy it instead. 12 years! 12 years I carried my lunch in a lousy paper sack. Never again!
Well, Mighty, if you get any static from Pearl on this, you can count on me being there, backing you all the way. A man's got to stand firm for what he believes. Boo! You take my wife, Elsie, boy.
Get up here on the double, Morton! Move!
Boo! See you later, Mighty. Gotta go now. I'm coming, Elsie.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I should have bought that cheese.
Well, Buster, where's that cheese?
What cheese, dear?
Don't what cheese me, mister. I told you to have that stuff tonight so when my mother gets here, we can all pack a picnic lunch and head out to the dog races. Speak up, bub. Spit it out. I can't hear you.
One of these days, Pearl. One of these days.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Pop. Hi.
Now, where were we?
Oh, yeah. Cut 'em on, Pearl!
been practicing her uppercut.
Phew! What a dream! Wait! It's almost time for me to go get married! Gotta buzz over to Vegas!
All present? Good. Let us begin. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say may be held against you.
No, no. That's the wrong speech, dog. This is supposed to be a wedding.
You're just checking. Do you, Pearl, pure heart, take this man Mighty Mouth to love and to cherish, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and honor?
I do, I do.
Oh, you're way ahead of me. And do you, Mighty Mouth, take this dear woman, Pearl, to be your lawfully wedded wife? Wife?
More cheese! Gotta eat!
To have and to hold, so long as you both shall live.
I can't go through with it! I can't do it! I can't marry him!
Yeah, I've been adrift for days. I'm tired of frozen breakfasts. Yuck.
Then follow my snoot to flavors of fruit.
Fruit?
Follow my nose.
I'm on your tail. Whoa!
It always knows.
Whoa!
Kellogg's Fruit Loop Cereal. With natural orange, lemon, and cherry flavors. And lots of vitamin C, part of this complete breakfast. Like them?
Yeah. They're cool.
It's time to play Win That Burger. Just follow the arrows, and what'll he win, Bertie?
A McDonald's cheeseburger!
Cheeseburger!
There he goes. He's up.
He's down.
He's up. And he's down. Does this guy love cheeseburgers or what? Congratulations, you hamburglar.
Follow the arrow.
Come on up. You won that burger.
Rubble, rubble, rubble.
He says he wants to play again same time tomorrow.
Ready? Set? Can you show us your bubble? Bubble Yum invites you to snap the fabulous bubbles you and your friends can blow with Bubble Yum Bubble Gum. The funniest, zaniest, most bubble bubble photo might win prizes like a VCR, limo rides, concert tickets, and over 2,000 cameras for runners-up. Want to show us your best Bubble Yum bubble?
With Bubble Yum.
Details in September magazines on specially marked packs or right bubble PO Box 7300, Wilton, Connecticut.
Now back to the new adventures of Mighty Mouse.
Hear ye, hear ye. Court is now in session. The people versus Mighty Mouse. Proceed, Perry Lard.
Thank you, Your Honor. The state's case is quite simple. We intend to prove, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that the defendant, the so-called Mighty Mouse, is responsible for the disappearance of Scrappy.
I object, Your Honor.
Overruled.
Yes, Scrappy, the tough but lovable orphan mouse. Oh, how we miss the sound of his melodious voice.
Everybody calls me Scrappy. I love to make the viewers happy. The kitties identify with me. I'm just as heartwarming as can be.
Yes, Scrappy was a truly wonderful character, full of concern for his fellow man.
Hey, kid, watch where you're putting that tire, boy. Hey, give me back my hat, you little miscreant.
It was full of little bugs anyway.
Yes, Scrappy seemed cheerful and happy, but it was only a mask to hide his true feelings.
I object, Your Honor.
Overruled. Sit down. But Scrappy was always in a good mood.
Yippee!
That's your story, Mr. Mouse, but the truth is entirely different. Scrappy's life was one of never-ending gloom and deprivation. For example, there was the time he went looking for a new home.
Yes? Hi, I'm Scrappy and I'm adorable. Will you be my mom?
Well, happy Mother's Day anyway.
Like, there's no one home, man.
We need mice. We need mice? Yeah! Can I live here?
His ears aren't round enough. No red shorts, no high-pitched voice. Oh, go to another network.
Things were not easy for Scrappy at school either.
Come on, Scrappy! You guys forgot the cheese whiz!
Thanks, Scrappy!
Yet, while poor little Scrappy suffered these indignities, what was his friend, Mighty Mouse, doing?
That's a lie!
Your Honor, the prosecution is out of order.
Overruled. Scrappy was my good friend. I always looked out for him.
Is that so? Then where were you when Scrappy was face to face with Elvis Potofkin and his cutthroat talent scouts?
Hey, look, the network water here.
Anyone could see these characters were not to be trusted.
What do you think, guys? Can we sell toys that look like this?
Oh no, it's an electrical storm!
This is better than my yoga class!
My lumbago.
Heck with this. Next time I'll take the bus.
I'm so nauseous. Somebody give me the Bromo.
You can't sit here. This is first class.
Yeah, but I'm a frequent flyer. Well, look at it this way. Things can't get worse.
Hey, are we near Anaheim yet?
Yeah, well, we must be. My wallet feels lighter already.
Well, it's a toll bridge, and I haven't got exact change. Yeah! Boxcar. Now we're gonna crash and there's nothing anyone can do.
What do you mean? I thought you were pals with Mighty Mouse.
Mighty Mouse? Mighty Mouse!
How did Mighty Mouse react to this?
That's not true! Your Honor, I demand a chance to tell my side!
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
You bet! get your bippy.
Proceed.
First of all, Your Honor, I was present on the night of the lightning storm.
Save us, Mighty Mouse!
Here I come to save the day. Not only did I save Scrappy and his sleazy agent, but I even arranged a little celebration for him.
Happy birthday, Scrappy! Happy birthday!
Hey, don't forget, I got 10% of the cake.
Happy birthday to Scrappy! Happy birthday to Scrappy!
But then I was always doing nice things for my pal, Scrappy.
Because he's such a mouse.
Many was the time when I would take my little comrade on a joyride through the clouds. Or cruise through outer space. I love this gravitational stuff. Ah, there is none. Fast as I can go. Or just a harmless little horseplay. What possible reason could I have for wanting to hurt Scrappy?
Isn't it true, Mr. Mouse, that just before his disappearance, Scrappy had started a new career as his own superhero?
Well, I,
Come, come, Mr. Mouse. Surely you must remember your chief competitor. The rust-colored rodent. As I remember, he was very popular among the younger mice. Wouldn't you say so?
What?
And isn't it true that your beloved pal, Scrappy, was the only person who knew your secret identity?
So, Mike, are you gonna let me in on this big secret, or do I have to have those pictures developed?
You gotta swear that you'll never reveal what I'm about to show you to anyone.
Cross my heart and hope to survive. Mighty Mouse!
Shh!
Mighty Mouse, my hero. And you've been right here beside me all this time.
Remember, Scrappy, this will be our little secret. Go to sleep now, Scrappy.
Yeah, sure. Gosh, me and Mighty Mouse. Now they can never write me out.
And shortly after that, he disappeared. Well, what have you to say to that?
Gentlemen
of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
Yes, Your Honor. We find the defendant, Mighty Mouse.
Hideous thing, what do you want?
Don't you recognize me? I'm your old pal, Scrappy!
Scrappy? We thought you were missing. Where were you?
I just got back from Camp 4 Mile Island. Give me a hug.
No, stay back. I'm warning you. I'll give you such a pinch.
It was all a dream. Yeah! Gosh, it was all a dream.
Gonna party here on CBS.
And now Project X.
Trix is always the sweet, fruity part of this complete breakfast. Now,
Trix is brighter!
Yay!
Brighter fruit-colored Trix? Let's eat!
Remember, new Trix is so bright, you gotta wear shades to eat it!
Shades?
Ready?
Yeah!
Raspberry red!
Orangey orange!
Lemony yellow!
Grapey purple!
Green!
Will the rabbit get new brighter tricks? Stay tuned.
Got any extra shades?
Ghostbusters!
Each sold separately.
Ghosts!
Our jet pack ready.
Ghost poppers loaded.
You scared?
Never.
You first.
PKE meter reads a class 3 ghost.
It's Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
Rooster!
Oh no, another one.
We ain't ghosts.
Stop him.
We ain't afraid of ghosts.
Proton pack and ghost popper gun. Each sold separately. The real Ghostbusters. From Kenner.
Her butterfly, it starts growing again.
Oh, golly, golly, my golly surprise.
You'll love the way her hair grows before your eyes. Dolly Surprise, each sold separately from Play School.
Snip. Snipperific.
Snipperific, smell terrific, instant Quaker oatmeal. Snipperific, taste terrific, instant Quaker oatmeal.
Instant Quaker oatmeal. The nose-teasing, taste-pleasing part of a nutritious breakfast.
Maple brown sugar, peaches and cream, apples and cinnamon are giving up steam.
11 snifferific, taste-terrific flavors.
Sniff-sniff-snifferific.
Instant Quaker oatmeal.
Snifferific.
Snifferific. Are you into the books or a bit of a clown? A Broadway baby or just hanging around? What kind of Campbell's kid are you?
Fruit Corners presents a new fruit snack, the Berry Bears.
Berry Bushes!
Where are we?
Someone's house.
The Berry Bears fruit snack.
Delicious, so fruity.
Bears! Kids!
Look, they've got
the Berry Bears fruit snacks. They look just like us. Mm.
You can take some home.
But how do we get home?
Use the door.
Fantastically fruity, the Berry Bears. And dangerously delicious shark bites. You can catch the fun at Fruit Corners.
See you next Saturday here on CBS.
That's a wrap.
Yeah!
This is CBS.
Downstairs any second.
I think you're more excited about Christmas than your son is.
What are you?
A Christmas present for Robert? That's all I've been told. What are you?
I don't know. What am I?
You must be for Christmas too.
Oh, here's Robert.
Christmas! It's Christmas!
Merry Christmas, son.
guess I'm not a rabbit. Maybe I'm a giraffe.
Do you like it?
I do. Oh, my rabbit. He's so beautiful.
Oh, that feels great.
Robert, open this one.
Wow!
It's a Scungili 333 TTI, an exact replica, and it runs.
Replica? Who's a replica? I'm a real thing. Watch.
Thanks. Where did Robert go?
Dad, look at this.
Oh, gosh, that's great.
I wish Robert would play with me again.
Oh, boy, I can't wait to see the new batch of toys.
I can wait. Christmas comes too fast around here. I hate to have the new toys see me this way. I'm a wreck.
Don't worry. Someday Robert will get interested in boats again. Ooh, here they come. Let's put everything all together over here.
Do I have to go to bed now? Can't I play with my toys?
You can play with them tomorrow.
Hey, what is this? I want to keep racing.
He'll play with us tomorrow.
That's what you think.
Who said that?
Look at those beat-up old things.
He'll play with us tomorrow. He knows us better.
Are you kidding? You look awful. Nobody plays with awful-looking toys.
I knew it. I just knew it.
Please don't cry. I never saw anything as wonderful-looking as you, whatever you are. Besides, Robert loves us all.
It doesn't work that way. I'm the most expensive gift he got. That makes me numero uno. You, are you made of velvet?
I'm made of velveteen.
Velveteen? Don't make me laugh. Velveteen is cheap stuff. Nobody loves cheap toys. Do you do anything spectacular? No. I'm real, you're not. Robert will never play with you.
That's not true. Is it?
We'll return after these messages.
Feel their power. Watch them soar. Bone Age, where cavemen fight in dinosaurs. Where Taro and Ankor battle to survive.
Taro, convert to land attack. Ankor, convert for chase.
Each sold separately. You can build fighters never seen before from the bones of these mighty dinosaurs. Bone Age.
Convert to survive. Fire!
Taro and Ankor sold separately with a caveman. Bone Age.
Here's something new and juicy. Here's something a whole lot of fun. New lightsaber, fruit juice, or candy. Real juice in everyone.
That's cool.
With the juice and fruit.
Introducing Teddy Grahams.
We just wanna eat tasty Teddy Grahams. Just a bunch of bite-sized bears. The fun to eat, oh man,
oh let them be.
Yo, Teddy Grahams. New lightly sweet, great to eat Graham snacks. Exploding with taste in honey, cinnamon, and chocolate.
Just wanna eat those Teddy Grahams.
Let's go.
friend is somebody you can turn to when you're in trouble.
We're gonna live forever.
Money from.
They might wear the same clothes, but we wear it in a different way.
Different taste. Yeah, well, I have better taste.
We don't think so.
Okay, now we're talking Thunderblade. One heavily armed attack copter. Evil forces trashing your city. 12 rounds of major air-to-ground destruction. An arcade classic. Allow me, note my aerial technique.
Hey, guys, come on, you'll get your turn.
Thunderblade. Just one of 70 games from Sega. And now look for the incredible Fantasy Star. Sega, major fun and games.
Wait a minute, Fantasy Star?
Sega's Thunderblade, Fantasy Star, and Master System sold separately.
Bill's Rice Krispies sounded great until...
Hush! Hush!
They stopped talking.
Hush!
Hey, put them down and snap to it.
Snap?
Yeah, snap! Whoa,
whoa. And the talking part of this complete breakfast returns.
Rice Krispies.
Now you can surprise your pop with new action poppers. It'll drive him up the wall. You can get one free in Rice Krispies.
And now back to CBS Storybreak.
A great toy.
I've seen his kind come and go.
Ouch! Didn't hurt.
My hull! My sleek hull now! Look what you did, you consarned land lover!
Ah! Keep out of the fast lane, you old tub!
Robert, there are too many toys on the floor.
Hello. Are you going to give me a nice squeeze? Look out. Oops. Oh, it's so dark. I'm afraid. Robert, take me out of here.
Don't be afraid. You got plenty of unused toys to keep you company.
Hey, Robbie, baby, what are you talking rocket ship? Get me started here. I'm hot today.
Hello, Robbie.
Here I am. Robbie.
I'm ready.
Robbie, we play.
Look out. Watch it. Look out. Easy.
Hi, Bunny Rabbit. How are you?
Well, I've been kind of lonely.
I found it.
Don't worry about it. Your time will come.
Oh, hi. I must have accidentally slipped out of his hands. Is that real?
Sure.
Are you real?
Sure.
But I'm not?
Not yet.
Does real mean having things that buzz inside you and a handle that sticks out?
Real isn't how you're made. It's a thing that happens to you. Love makes you real. When a child loves you for a long, long time, not just to play with, but really loves you, then you become real. Once you're real, you can't become unreal again. It lasts for always.
Oh, I want very much to be real.
Untidy, very, very untidy.
Oh, no, we're getting tidied up again. All hands on deck.
Tidy the... toys. Tidy the toys. I'm forever tidying the toys.
Ouch! Easy on the flapper. Sorry. I'm sorry. It's a good thing I'm a soft toy.
Look out! Duck, Velvie!
Whoops. Are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. I want out of here. Just give me new batteries and I'll be faster than ever.
Don't worry. Robert will take you out tomorrow and get you new batteries. Try to rest in the meantime.
Rest? Me? Sure, rest. I should rest. I've got a lot of races left in me. Thanks. You're not very expensive, but you're okay, Velvie.
Doggy! Where's Doggy?
Probably left him downstairs. You can have him tomorrow.
I want Doggy now. Won't sleep without him.
Don't you try that trick on me, young man. Now go to sleep, Robert.
I don't want to sleep without my doggy.
All right. I'll find you something.
Me.
Ah, I know he likes you.
Ouch!
Velvie, this is the opportunity of your lifetime. Try to stay clean. It's very important.
I'll try. I'll play it by... Ouch! Ear.
Here's an old friend of yours.
My bunny rabbit!
Now, go to sleep. Good night.
Oh, that feels great.
Good night, bunny rabbit.
Oh, I've been waiting for this. Look out! You're flattening me. Get me out of here. I can hardly breathe. Ouch! Remember, I'm a rabbit, not a football. Easy now. Don't move. Don't move.
Get the tow truck, somebody.
He's sunk.
He's out of that bed forever.
Oh, well, it's his bed. Ugh. Good morning. Oops.
Where are you taking me?
Welcome back to the garage.
I knew it wouldn't last.
What are you doing to my bunny rabbit?
Everything in its place. Tidy, tidy.
He belongs on my bed. Please? There you are, bunny rabbit.
Come along, Robert. Time for breakfast.
Oh, Bunny Rabbit, where are you? Are you okay, Bunny Rabbit? Your ears are getting stiff. Gotta go faster, faster. Look out, here comes the monster.
Oh, get me out of here.
Don't worry, I won't let the monster get you. I love you too much.
What a ride! This sure beats being chased around under the covers by that monster.
Here comes the monster!
Oh, he's out here too?
I'll hide you. Now you're safe.
Robert, time for cookies and milk.
Be right back.
Okay, guess I'll wait here.
Where's my bunny rabbit? I left him outside.
Get back into bed, young man. I'll get you something else to sleep with.
He's never been alone outside. You'll be scared. Get him, please. Please?
Don't be silly. Get into bed.
I can't sleep without him. Get my bunny rabbit, please.
Oh, that's the monster. Oh, no, I have time for...
Oh, here you are.
So what took you so long?
Wet and dirty, wet and dirty.
Careful with the tail, please. It's not on so good.
My bunny rabbit!
such a mess.
I'm so sorry, Bunny Rabbit. I don't ever want to lose you.
All this fuss for just a toy?
He isn't a toy. He's real.
I'm real. I'm real. I'm a real rabbit. Did you hear that, everybody? Congratulations. I'm you. You make it.
That's a wonderful
congratulations. I'm real. I'm real. I'm real. Oh, I'm real.
I have to explore the woods. Wait here for me.
What's that? Oh, can't be that monster. Robert told me monsters aren't real.
Say, Brenda!
What is it, Harry? What kind of ridiculous rabbit is that?
Are you battery-powered? I don't see wind-up keys sticking out of your backs.
Battery-powered? Wind-up keys? What sort of language is that?
Are you an outer space rabbit?
No, I'm just a regular real rabbit. You've got beautiful fur. I can't even see your seams.
We don't have seams, do we, Brenda?
Of course not. Hey, you want to play with us?
I'd love to, but I'm waiting for someone. I have an appointment.
Can you do this?
Or this?
Not on a full stomach.
Come on, dance with us.
Take a look at this. No hind legs.
I do have hind legs. I'm sitting on them.
He's an imposter.
Phony as a rubber carrot.
He's not real.
He's unreal.
He's a decoy. It's a trap.
Come back. I'll try to dance with you. I'm real. Robert said so. I'm real. I'm real. I am real.
We'll return after these messages.
Time to make the donuts.
Introducing a big idea from a giant in the business, the world's smallest donuts.
Ta-da!
In new Dunkin' Donuts cereal, you get delicious, crunchy little donuts by the hundreds. All your favorite donut shapes, ring holes, and twists. You can choose rich chocolate or glazed donut flavors, or both as part of a nutritious breakfast. Dunkin' Donuts cereal. Crunchy little donuts, great big taste.
Time to eat the donuts.
I know a boy, his name is Zach. He loves to fit, he loves to stack. Yes, construction is his knack. He's Zach, a Lego maniac. He builds in the window, he's off the wall. He builds them big, he builds them small. In Legoland, he'll rock and roll. He's Lego wild, out of control. Zach, he's a Lego maniac.
Legoland, King's Castle, Airport, Cosmic Fleet Voyager, sold separately from Lego Systems.
Now back to CBS Storybreak.
I can't wait to see the new batch of toys.
I can wait. I heard Robert was getting a real submarine. How can I compete with that?
I wonder who will be Robert's new favorite.
He'll always love Velvy.
That bunny's too shabby looking. The new toys will make him look sick.
Here they come.
What wonderful toys. Which is your favorite? The robot? The flying saucer?
My bunny rabbit. Merry Christmas, bunny. I love to drag you around, Bunny Rabbit. I feel sick, Bunny Rabbit.
Nana, Robert's sick. The doctor says it's very contagious and Robert's room will have to be quarantined.
Bunny Rabbit.
Yuck.
I'd take it for you if I could. Oh, you'll be okay soon, Robert. Then we can go outside and play in the woods and we can make believe the monster is chasing me.
rhinoceros and a tiger and a zebra.
The doctor said he can get out of bed. We're taking him to the seashore for a few days. The ocean air and sun will be good for him.
The seashore? We're going to the seashore, Bunny Rabbit.
We're going to the seashore. Tugboat, you'll have to come too. You'll love it.
I'm all set. Hoist anchor!
The entire room must be fumigated.
Yes, Mom.
The doctor said that all the bedclothes, all these things he was in contact with, must be burned.
What was that? What does burned mean?
Don't know. Never heard of it.
Whatever it is, it doesn't sound good.
What about his old toy bunny? He loves it.
The doctor warned me it's loaded with germs. Anyone who touches it could get very sick. We should burn it at once.
Help, Robert. Oh, this has gone far enough. Robert, it's me, your favorite rabbit. I'm in the trash bag.
You'll have a wonderful time at the seashore.
I know. I can't wait.
Don't go away without me, Robert. Don't leave me.
My bunny rabbit! My bunny rabbit! We forgot my bunny rabbit! Stop!
Don't be silly. You'll only be gone for a week.
Oh, Robert, goodbye.
Burned. That's what burned means.
Oh, no, not me. What good is it to be loved and become real if it all ends like this?
Hello, Velvy. Do you know who I am? I am the nursery magic fairy.
You better get out of here before the gardener sees you and you end up like me.
He can't see me. No one but you can see me.
Well, what are you doing here?
I watch over all the old toys that have worn out from too much loving. I'm here to take you away and make you real.
But I am real. And look where it got me.
You were real only to the boy. Now you shall be real to everyone. I brought you a new friend. Please be kind to him and teach him all he needs to know.
Oh, I remember that toy bunny.
He's so out of it. He can't somersault. He just sits there tilted. Not bad, kid. What's your name?
Velvy.
Listen, Velvy, can you do a double somersault?
I feel like I can do a triple.
He's dynamite!
Civilization around here. Remember when the woods used to be woods, Harry?
I remember, Brenda.
It's Robert, the kid I used to belong to.
When you were a pet?
Oh, I wasn't a pet. I was a toy. His toy.
Oh, hello, Bunny Rabbit. What are you doing here? You're cute. I used to have a bunny rabbit like you. I used to love my bunny rabbit. I'd love to hug you the way I hug my bunny rabbit. Please let me hug you. I miss my bunny rabbit. I wish I could have had him forever.
Robert, time for cookies and milk.
Oh, please, bunny rabbit, don't run away. Please?
Whom are you talking to?
A bunny rabbit. He let me pick him up. He looked just like my old bunny. The one that was lost when I went away. Just like him.
I remember how you loved that old thing. But you have lots of other toys to play with.
Goodbye, Robert. Thanks for making me real.
Be
return after these messages.
Kitty O's like scarecrows. They can play on a train with chopsticks, watching tricks in the dark. They can shark, watch out. Wearing glasses, banging brass, and coaster. Or you could eat O's like we're supposed to. Spaghetti was playing with meatballs.
Standing on the corner, wondering if I'm gonna, don't know if I wanna, but then again I might.
Dutical, what's a dutical accent?
Oh gee, it's original, California. I think it's cool.
Cool.
I agree. Even radical. Yeah.
Don't know what it's all about. I keep drifting in and out.
And now back to CBS Storybreak. Now this message.
Okay, now we're talking Thunderblade. One heavily armed attack copter. Evil forces trashing your city. 12 rounds of major air-to-ground destruction. An arcade classic. Allow me. Note my aerial technique.
Hey, guys, come on, go get your turn.
Thunderblade. Just one of 70 games from Sega. And now look for the incredible Fantasy Star. Sega. Major fun and games.
Wait a minute, Fantasy Star.
Sega's Thunderblade, Fantasy Star, and Master System sold separately.
Who can forget their first date?
Hi.
That first look, that first touch, and that first burping contest.
I can't believe that.
Raised in Miranda Saturday.
Hey, Vern and Ernest! Wild and crazy fun!
Know what I mean?
Seconds left in the championship game. Ellie down by one. Jenkins with the ball. Crosses the midcourt line. England picks him up and attack man to man. Jenkins, defense right. He gets left. He drives to the basket. No, he pulls up down the knee. He jumps. He shoots. It's in the air. Yeah! Jenkins
does it! Nice shot, kid.
DP Shotbuster and Duncan Dinosaur, complete with ball, decals, and easy height-adjustable goal.
Ronald McDonald and the Chicken McNuggets and Baby Talk.
This reminds me of when you guys were babies.
Tell us about it, Ronald.
Yeah! I remember when you took your first step.
What's that first step?
When you learned to read.
Oh!
Your first birthday. Your first word. And your first dip. Barbecue sauce. Now you're all grown up.
Right!
But don't forget the nightlight.
Snip. Snip terrific. Instant Quaker oatmeal.
Instant Quaker oatmeal. When it smells this good, it's got to taste even better.
Snip terrific, taste terrific. Instant Quaker oatmeal.
11 snifferific, taste terrific flavors. Part of this nutritious breakfast.
Apple, cinnamon, snifferific.
Snip, snip, snifferific.
Instant Quaker oatmeal.
Little Miss Makeup, we're going to a party.
She's Little Miss Makeup, the magical doll.
You'll need your eyeshadow.
Ooh, purple earrings, too.
And your red nail polish.
Wow. Just use cold and warm water.
Now, should I put your lipstick on or take it off?
Let's put it back on.
And with your sweetheart, we'll be the hit of the party.
Little Miss Makeup comes with a play suit and a party dress you can change. Little Miss Makeup, only from Mattel.
Dinosaurs from Chef Boyardee. Taste wholesome pasta that's a dinosaur hunt. Cause first one to capture all three dinosaur shapes wins.
Thanks to Chef Boyardee. Dinosaurs.
And with meatballs.
Potato News. Princess Fry denies rumors she's expecting a royal sprout. The Washington Potato Skins won the championship, but the hottest news is Hot Potato. Hot Potato makes his own music in this game. You gotta keep him moving, because if you got him when the music stops, you're starting to get hot. And when you get hot, you're not. Hot Potato is one cool spud. That's it from your commentator.
Hot Potato, the musical potato action game. New from Parker Brothers.